things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you.
Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Back here at David Clark Stadium, home of the East Lincoln Mustangs, as you are currently listening to the Owl and Kubota of Lincoln to pregame show on the SD7 Lincoln County Game of the Week. I'm Evan Ludwig, joined by Jason Barber, and we are now going to introduce the starting lineups for both the West Caldwell Warriors and the East Lincoln Mustangs.
Yes, we'll start with the visiting Warriors. We have the offensive lineup. Starting at quarterback is number 13, junior Titus Tucker. Oh, he's a senior. That's here. He's a junior. 6'3", 195, and we know he's not only the quarterback, he's the return guy, he is the safety, and he's the punter. He doesn't come off the field just for Mr. Tucker. Starting at tailback is number 6, Trustin Harper. At one wide receiver position is number 2, Deshaun Francis. At another wide receiver position is number 10, Bishop Kidd. The other wide receiver is number 14, Taylor Kunkel. And rounding out the receivers is number 23, Elijah Brooks. And we've seen him. He doesn't need much room to get going. He took a screen pass and went 89 yards. We saw that before. So
cutting all over the place.
Yes, he was. And on the offensive line there for West Caldwell, starting at right tackle is number 76, Isaiah Hams. At right guard is number 56, Jalen Perkins. At center, number 75, Dalton Stepps. At left guard is number 55, Vada Perkins. And at left tackle, number 74, Corey Hartley. And for the Mustangs on offense, led by All-American Chaz Surratt, quarterback there for the Mustangs, senior, 6'3", 210 pounds. Joining him in the backfield is running back Colton Banks, senior running back, 5'11", 185. At the wide receiver's position is junior Cameron Dollar, junior Sage Surratt. Other wide receiver is senior Nick Quigley. And at tight end is number 49, senior Darren Martin. On the offensive line, starting at right tackle is number 68, Austin Lunsford. At right guard is number 72, Jonathan Parks. At center, number 51, Gage Welburn. At left guard is number 54, Devin Rigdon. At left tackle is number 71, A.J. Presley.
Yeah, and we want to mention something. We've been hearing about these records, mostly for Chaz Surratt. Want to get in that, but quickly, we heard today in the press box just a couple minutes ago that T.J. McClain for the Mustangs needs 6 tackles tonight to become the all-time leading tackler in East Lincoln Mustang history.
Yes, Mr. McClain there, he is a senior linebacker. And then don't forget, Sage Surratt is on the verge of hitting some county records as far as receiving records there. So a lot of records on the line here. And then, of course, Chaz is pursuing the touchdown record. So he just became the all-time leading rusher in the county of Lincoln County last week. So these guys here is the record. But you go through, look at the Lincoln County record, but it's going to see nothing but Surratt going down the line.
Yeah, we're probably going to be Surratt. And those will probably stay there for a long time unless something immediately changes. But I highly doubt that. Yeah, Chaz Surratt, the main one is the most touchdowns in North Carolina high school football history. He currently has 203. And Chris Leake's the leader right now, former Independence quarterback in the late 90s, early 2000s, and then went on to Florida and won a national championship under Urban Meyer. They blew out Ohio State in that game. He has 216, so, I mean, it's not out of reach. He'll probably get it maybe within 2-3 weeks possibly. Yeah. Just depends on what happens here. But it does look like Chaz Surratt will get that record. So it's, I mean, been an amazing 4 years for Chaz Surratt.
Yes, and people forget, remember, he did not start as a freshman at quarterback. He was a receiver, and he was a record-breaking receiver there as a freshman. And then he took over quarterbacking duties his sophomore year and hasn't looked back. So it's been a great career, and I know it's not over yet. They have tonight. Senior night next week, and then they close out the season with West Lincoln. And of course, all those games we'll be bringing those games to you here on KTCBroadcasting.com and LincolnCounty.com, and then of course the playoff run.
Yeah, if you're East Lincoln, though, you can't take these guys lightly. I know you've been dominating the series lately, but we've seen this West Caldwell team. They've looked pretty well right now, and a lot of people were saying it's them and Maiden that are going to be the wild card teams in this SD7 this year, and it looks like that has become true. Maiden being a contender, actually.
Yeah, Maiden's undefeated in conference play, and we'll pull up the standings here in the SD7 standings. And while we got them, of course, we have East Lincoln sitting atop the standings 4-0. And then conference play at 4-0, 8-0 overall. Then Maidens right behind, tied with them for first place in the SD7 at 4-0, 7-1 overall. Then Lincolnton and West Caldwell are tied at 3-1, Lincolnton 6-2, West Caldwell 5-3. Then Newton Conover and West Lincoln are 1-3 in conference play. Newton and West both with 4-4 records overall. And then Bandys and Bunker Hill are winless in conference play, and Bandys is winless overall at 0-8, and Bunker Hill is 2-6. And now we do know that West Lincoln will not be playoff eligible this year due to too many players being ejected from the ball game. They are not playoff eligible, although they have the four wins.
Right. We did see some of that happen 2 weeks ago when we were at the West Lincoln Newton Conover game. So, and then last week, I believe there was a couple against West Caldwell. As West Caldwell cruised into victory, they didn't score anything in the second half, won 42-0 at West Lincoln.
Yes. And then just some other standings. We talked about some games in the SMAC that we're covering on KTC and the Southern Piedmont. The SMAC conference is Shelby and Crest. Shelby leading that conference at 6-0, 9-0 overall. It's Crest at 5-0, 8-0 overall. Then Kings Mountain comes in at 4-2, 7-2 overall. East Burke, 3-2. 4-4 overall. East Rutherford 2-3, 4-4 overall. Drawn 2-4. Burns 1-4. RS Central 1-4. And then Chase 0-5 in the South Mountain Athletic 2A. And then the Southern Piedmont. It's a tie for first between Community School of Davis and the Pine Lake Prep at 3-0 each. The Pine Lake Prep being undefeated overall at 8-0. And Thomas Jefferson 2-1, 6-1 overall. Terrible 1-1, now 1-7 overall. Bessemer 1-2. And that's what tonight's game is keeping them trying to stay in that conference race. Mountain Island Charter 1-4 in conference play, and Highland Tech 0-3.
Yeah, so the three conferences that we were just going over, it's basically either a two-man race, and then the Southern Piedmont Conference, somewhat of a three-horse race, with Community School Davidson, Pine Lake Prep, and Thomas Jefferson.
Yes.
So Big South, it's basically South Point's the loser and undefeated right now. Forest View's 3-1, but they got a big test tonight against the Ashbrook Green Wave. That should be an interesting one, to say the least. East Gaston needs to win this game tonight against North Gaston and Stuart Kramer.
They're 2-2 in conference, and they play Hunter Huss, and this is a big matchup to who get that number one 2A seed out of the Big South Conference and out of that conference for playoff purposes, because that number one seed will have a home playoff game.
Yeah, and I mean, this is the first year they've had four classes, senior, sophomore, senior, junior, sophomore, freshman, and they already have four wins. But if they can get this conference win, they pretty much got it locked and loaded that they are going to be have a home playoff game, and that would be so big for that young program.
Yes, school only been playing football for the last 3 years now.
Two years with varsity.
2 years of varsity, 3 years overall. And then the North Piedmont, 3A4 before we take a break. The South Iredale leading that conference at 4-0 overall, followed by Lake Norman, Mooresville at 3-1. North Iredale, Statesville at 2-2. Alexander Central, North Lincoln at 1-3. And then West Iredale, 0-4 in the North Piedmont, 3A4A.
All right, we'll take a quick commercial break as you are currently listening to the Outland Kubota of Lincolnton pregame show.
Here's some good policy from your local independent agent and auto owner's insurance. When you insure your home and car with us, you receive a multi-policy discount. And when you add auto owner's life insurance, you get a special discount on your home and car insurance. Auto owner's insurance will save you money on all of the insurance you already have. Now that's good policy. Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people.
Your local auto insurance agency is East Lincoln Insurance Agency on Highway 60 North in Denver. Give them a call at 704-483-3222. It's hard to believe First Federal Savings Bank has been serving this area for over 75 years. It's because of local people working and living right here in the community they serve. And they believe in giving back to the community by supporting our local schools, charities, and nonprofits. Services include checking accounts, savings, money markets, CDs, mobile banking, and online banking, with locations in Lincolnton, Bogart City, Denver, and West Lincoln. Online at ffsb-nc.com. An equal housing lender and member FDIC. The new Coyote 3510 tractor is now in stock at Weston Sales in Vail. It's what you've been waiting for, a 34 horsepower Coyote tractor for only $17.99. And now you can take $2,500 off all Coyote DK Series tractors. Plus, get a free loader on all Coyote CK Series tractors. And buy a new Coyote UTV and get 0% financing. Come on in now for all the details at Weston Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail. Online at westonsales.com. It's time to book your Christmas party now. And there's no better place in our area than Homestead's Grill and Tap House in Lincoln. With two banquet rooms available with accommodations up to 125. Plus, they do on- and off-site caterings such as wedding rehearsal dinners, birthdays, showers, and more. Check out the NFL Sunday ticket, plus all-you-can-eat ribs, wings, and salad bar Friday and Saturdays for $19.99. And try the new US 1 short rib burger for only $9.49. Homestead's Grill and Tap House, 357 North Generals Boulevard in Lincoln, and coming in November, a new additional location in Denver. Get the cutting edge. Get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower that raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best. Cut with the Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700.
It's the end of the season tire blowout sale at Full Throttle Power Sports in Gastonia. Michelin Pilot Power tires start at $99.99 and Continental Motion tires start at $75. Plus, get end of the season deals on the remaining Yamaha watercraft. Plus, great motorcycle deals like a 2015 Yamaha R3 for $49.90 and the new 2015 Yamaha FZ6R for $69.89. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 off I-85 at 100 Indian Walk in Lowell. Online at ncfullthrottle.com.
Back here at East Lincoln High School, David Clark Stadium, as we are about ready for the coin toss, as the captains for the Mustangs are number 32, which is Torrey Haynes, senior linebacker, number 49, Darren Martin, senior linebacker, and number 21, Colton Banks, who's also a senior.
Senior running back. And if captains for West Caldwell is number 2, Deshaun Francis, who's playing wide receiver tonight. Quarterback, Titus Tucker. Running back, number 6, Trustin Harper. And offensive lineman, number 57, Nick Pitts.
So coin toss here coming right up as the band's getting in formation for the Mustangs to run out. As if you haven't been watched an East Lincoln game at East Lincoln, they did get a inflatable helmet to run through, which has got pretty cool, honestly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's very cool. I wish I had one of those when I played ball.
Yeah, as only two teams to have one in this area, or the area that we cover, are Crest and East Lincoln.
East Lincoln and Maiden. Maiden has
Maiden, one. Yes, Maiden has one, too.
Pretty cool. Pretty cool. I'm getting ready for the coin toss here. And we do have a news station here tonight. Don't know where it's from, but the cameraman is down at the 50-yard line there filming the coin toss. And, again, shout out to Shandy, our cameraman tonight.
Doing a great job, as always. Great crowd out here tonight for both sides. West Caldwell got a lot of people traveling there and more people coming out. Pink night here at East Lincoln High School.
Pink night. Toss is up.
I believe East Lincoln won the toss. And they will defer.
They want to get that possession to start the second half. And East is so good. And we saw it again last week, scoring just before halftime. And then also scoring on that opening possession the second half. So.
Well, and remember, the last time we were here at East Lincoln was when they played North Lincoln. Mm-hmm. North Lincoln tried an onside kick. And Cameron Dollar got the ball at about the 45 and then tossed it back to Chas Ratt. And he returned it to the end zone for a touchdown.
They start that second half kickoff. Yeah, and so, East is so good. I mean, we hear the stat with the New England Patriots, how they're so good. The scoring just before half and then scoring start the second half. For compared, I had to put East Lincoln on that level with the Patriots in doing so.
Yes, been great couple of years for the East Lincoln Mustangs, and they're looking to continue that. But we can't get ahead of ourselves. We're here tonight. We're not even in the playoffs yet. Season's almost over, but the Mustangs are ready to play against this Warriors team that has been really good this year.
Oh, yes. Nevin, let's take a quick break. Look like they're waiting on the teams to bust the banner. So let's take a quick break. So when we come back, we'll be ready for the kickoff.
All right, Mustang fans, it's time to get up. Oh, wait, here they come.
Oh, here they come. Oh, no, they shot me. Here they go.
Yeah, they shocked you here.
Yeah,
and
did.
Here come the Mustangs.
Here comes your Mustang.
The undefeated Mustangs, last time they lost a game was, you have to go all the way back to 2013, and it was a playoff game against Monroe. And Monroe is also, I believe, an undefeated team as well right now.
Yes,
so
are.
Not a bad team to lose to, but I know if those two teams do face in the playoffs, this, you know, don't know if it'll happen or not, but you know the Mustangs will be pumped because they want to get revenge on the Redhawks.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Still waiting on the Warriors to take the field. I guess they're getting some last-minute pep talk, but the Mustangs already got their kickoff team out in the field.
Yeah, and the officials are taking their place, so they're ready.
And
so just waiting on the Warriors.
Now here come the Warriors. It's taking their time, though, and now they're starting to hurry onto the field. I think they now realized they're a little late coming out.
Yeah.
Once again, the Warriors will be receiving the opening kickoff here at David Clark Stadium. East Lincoln undefeated. West Caldwell 5-3, 3-1 in conference play, but the only telling stat that I saw Ryan Herman write in the paper today was that West Caldwell has not beaten a team above 500.
No, they have not. No, they have not. So this will be another strong test for them because their one loss in conference play did come to Maiden this year.
Right, it did come to Maiden, and they're going through a hard – I mean, they're going – like you said last week, they're torn Lincoln County. Last week they took care of West Lincoln. This week they're going against East Lincoln, and next week they're going to be going against Lincolnton.
Yes. Going to return and back deep for West Caldwell will be Titus Tucker. Like we said, he's a quarterback, return man, the punter, and the safety. So,
and kicking off for the Mustangs is Blake Strupp, the senior kicker.
Yes, he's a play kicker, and he does play defensive back as well. Let me see.
Did see Strupp kick a 55-yard field goal perfectly, and he had a little bit more leg with that one. So don't really see him get those opportunities, though.
And the Mustangs tonight wearing the all-orange look, and the Warriors going with the all-white look.
And just moments away from the opening kickoff here at David Clark Stadium. And we are underway. And the ball is going to bounce. Titus Tucker takes it about the 3-yard line. He's at the 10, the 15, the 20. Going to cut into the inside, jumps over a defender, and he's fallen the blockers and is out at about the 31-yard line. So the Warriors will have it at their own 31-yard line to start the drive.
Good return there. Getting about 28 yards there on the return. And this East Lincoln defense, like I said, they have not given up 30 points all season. The most they've given up is 28. And name to look out for is Mr. Trevor Childers.
Also T.J. McClain.
T.J. McClain, again, 6 tackles away from breaking this all-time tackle record.
And they're going to go with a pass play here. Titus Tucker steps up into the pocket. Looks like he's going to scramble and is taken down maybe at the line of scrimmage. Maybe they're going to give him a yard. Looks like he was taken down on the play by number 84, Will Mercer.
Yep.
Well, Titus Tucker's on the sideline. He's limping.
Uh-oh.
This is not good for the Warriors.
No, it's not. And they did get a gain of 1 there. Spot the ball at 32.
Not a good way to start the game if you're the Warriors. Your quarterback goes down. He did get off the field, though.
And in the play now, quarterback is number 11, Caleb Dula.
Dula, there's a lot of Dulas on this team. He is a sophomore quarterback. And he's going to hand it off to Harper. Harper escapes some tackles, is going to get up and probably get about 2 or 3 yards.
Let's see where they mark him. I think they're going to mark him around the 33. Trusting. They're going to mark it at the 34, so give him a gain of 2 for Trusting Harper. And on the tackle, there's number 61, and that's Keegan Burke.
So, third and long coming out. I do think I see Titus Tucker is on the sidelines. I don't think he's on the bench anymore. I do not know, though. But third down coming up. Harper beside Dula. Dula's going to drop back. So looks like a screen pass and off the hands of Harper. That's going to make it a quick 3-and-out to start the game for the Warriors.
And not the start that you want if you're if you're West Caldwell.
And going back deep for the Mustangs to return to punt is number 4, Cameron Dollar. We hear about the Surratts, but Cameron Dollar is quite the player too.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's a second leading receiver on this team, just behind Sage Surratt.
And
back punt is not Titus Tucker. Let's get a number here.
I think it's number 15. No, 16.
And fair catch call by Cameron Dollar, who's going to let the ball bounce. It's going to bounce at the 30. Takes the West Caldwell bounce to the 25. Luck is going to be spotted down at the 24-yard line.
So Titus Tucker, don't know his status right now, but he does play some free safety as well. Doesn't look like he's taken the field. So big blow for West Caldwell if it's anything serious.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
All right, the Mustangs will have their first drive at the 24-yard line. And one thing we know about this East Lincoln offense, blink and you miss with some of these touchdown plays they have.
Yes, they are quick striking, one play, two play. They can get it done in 5 seconds or 10 seconds. We know about this Mustang.
Jazz is going to take the snap. Snap going to drop back under pressure, going to roll out to his right, and he scrambled, fumbled the play, and it's recovered by number 14 of the Warriors, and that is Tyler Kunkel. He's going to return it for a touchdown. So, three and out drive for West Caldwell in offense, but a fumble by Chas Verratt and right place, right time.
Yeah, and it fumbled around the 20, look, the flag, it fumbled around the 22-yard line. And so it went in for 22 yards there for number 14. And that's, again, as you said, Tyler Kunkel. Oh,
Taylor Kunkel, my
Taylor
bad.
Kunkel, excuse me.
That's my fault there. Talk about right place, right time. I don't think Chaz knew the defender was that
not
close
coming,
to him.
Coming behind him, he had the ball loosely in his left hand, and it was poked away.
And point after is up, and it knocks on the goalpost. It is no good. So, on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincolnton scoreboard here, with 10:14 left in the first quarter, it is West Caldwell 6, East Lincoln nothing.
It's the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincolnton. Get $1,000 in rebates on select Kubota tractors, plus zero money down, zero financing for 60 months. Offer good on the Kubota L Series and the Kubota BX Series tractors. But hurry, offer in soon. Don't miss the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincolnton, 3636 East Highway 27 in Lincolnton. Online at KubotaOfLincolnton.com.
Back here at David Clark Stadium as the West Caldwell Warriors are up 6-0 early in the ballgame after a fumble was recovered by Taylor Kunkel, a Chas Verratt holding the ball a little too loosely on that play.
And that was a 28-yard fumble return there by Mr. Kunkel.
All right, back deep receiving for the kickoff for the Mustangs is number 21, Colton Banks, and kicking off for the Warriors is number 16, Zach Clay. It's going to be a pooch kick. It's going to go to number 20, I believe. No, 28, Trevor Childers. He's going to be met at about the 35-yard line.
Most things here are going to have to try to shake off that first play.
Kickoff return by number 28, Trevor Childers.
And a score of interest here in the ST7. Lincolnton's already up 13-0 after Cordell Littlejohn has a pick. After a pick leads to a Cordell Littlejohn 28-yard pass to Langdon Givens. That's his favorite target. So Chas Verratt looking to correct that mistake there and get the Mustangs going.
Starting at that 36-yard line.
Verratt takes a snap. Drops back. He's going to throw it to the flats where Sage Verratt's at. Sage Verratt cuts the defender. He's still on his feet, across the 40, and is stopped at about the 41-yard line.
Stopped by number 10, Bishop Kidd, on the tackle. And they're gonna mark him there at the 41-yard line. So that'd be gain of 5 on that reception for Sage.
For most receivers there, that would have only been about a gain of 2, but Sage Verratt can get through defenders so well, it was a gain of 5 there. So huge credit to Sage on that play. Right, trips to the left. Surratt, Childers, and Quigley to the left. Cameron to the right. Colton Banks is behind Chaz. Chaz going to look deep on this play. Sage Surratt wide open. He's caught it, and he drops it.
Drops the ball right there just at the 24-yard line. He had beat the two defenders. He had got behind the two defenders there and on the post pattern.
And to make things worse for East Lincoln, a flag on the field. It is holding against the Mustangs, so that'll move them back. But so even with the drop, it wouldn't have mattered. It was going to be coming back either way. So, but it's weird. You don't really see that from both any of the receivers, as Chase had a rare drop there.
And that'll push him back. That'll push them back to the 33-yard line.
Yeah, still second down, second about 13. Chaz takes a snap. It's going to be a read option here. He's going to pitch it out to Colton Banks. Colton Banks is going to get down the sideline and looks like he's out of bounds at around the 40-yard line, or sort of the 40-yard line at the 39. It's going to make it about third and six coming up for the Mustangs.
Looks like they're going to spot the ball just at the 39-yard line. Gain of six for Mr. Banks.
And East Lincoln trying to get the first Walker Pharmacy and Newton first down of the ball game, as we're almost 3 minutes in, still no first down technically in the ball game.
Brings it third and seven for the Mustangs.
And it's going to be a screen, slant pass to Sage Rett. Sage catches it easily, and a fumble on the play, and it's recovered by number five, Tykeese Davidson. He's got a lot of room. He's at the 10 to 5, and touchdown, two fumbles.
And he recovered. There's a flag on the play, but it was covered. The fumble recovered there at the 49-yard line.
This is just wacky here. Another right place, right time play for the Warriors defense. But this one looks like it's going to come back here.
Yeah, let's see what the penalty is.
This ball, the flag's at the 25-yard line. Personal foul against the Warriors, so the touchdown will not count. But it will be will be Warriors ball, I do believe. That'll move them back to their Mustang 40-yard line.
Yeah, they'll start. Take away the touchdown, but they start inside Mustang territory there at the 40-yard line.
And do not see Mr. Titus Tucker coming out into the ball field. So it looks like that injury is pretty severe. So that not good for the Warriors, but they're up 6-0. And should be for – it's first and 10, but chain crew's just now getting chain set up. So, first.
On that completion, it was a 10-yard completion, got to the 40, fumble right there at the 49-yard line.
And West Caldwell kind of confused with who's going in and out, and a flag, and that's going to cost them.
Illegal substitution. Had too many men. Broke the huddle with 12 men on the field there.
Can't be doing this stuff if you're the Warriors. Just. Got two turnovers.
Yeah, and then, you have to play a perfect game if you're going to try to beat the East Lincoln Mustangs.
Right, and at quarterback now is number 11, Caleb Dula, a sophomore. He was in there the last drive, and we're seeing them go under center now. Dula's going to take the snap, going to hand it off to Harper. He's going to cut to the right side. He's got some room. He's at the 40. He's at the 35, and he's still on his feet at the 30, and is stopped at about the 25-yard line, 27 maybe.
Look like they're spotting them at the 27-yard line. So,
and that'll be good enough for Walker Pharmacy and Newton first down.
18, yep, giving gain of 18 there on the carry.
As Harper's edging closer to 1,000 yards this year. Still under the I formation is Dula. He's going to hand it off to Harper once again. He's bunched up there by the East Lincoln defenders. He got more than a couple, probably about four.
Let's see where they spot him.
Looks like at about the 24-yard line.
Number six, Preston Harper, the ball carrier. Stop by number
give
24.
Give him a gain of three.
As I believe the injury to Titus Tucker is pretty severe. He's
he's not back in after that first play for scrimmage for him.
Yeah, the trainers are working on him at the other side of the field, so looks like maybe the ankle or something. Dula takes a snap. He's going to pitch it out to Harper to the left side. He's at 25, cuts up to the inside, then goes outside. As there's a flag on the field as
he's flag thrown down at the 20-yard line. That's going to be coming back.
Yeah.
Flag's thrown there towards the 20-yard line. Let's see.
As West Caldwell is not really helping themselves, they have an opportunity right now to maybe get a two-touchdown advantage possibly over the Mustangs.
Yep, so it's holding on the play.
Right.
And the penalty is going to be marked off on the 20, so give Mr. Harper a gain of four on the carry up to where the flag was. And ball will be spotted back at the 30-yard line.
And this is one thing the Mustangs haven't really been used to. They've been trailing. I
It's not often that they trailed this season.
And Lincolnton scoring all over Newton Conover. Another touchdown pass by Littlejohn. They're now up 21-0. It's going to be a pitch out to Harper again. This time to the right side. He's met in the backfield.
Yes, he is. And first there to stop him is looks to be number one, Jalen Scott.
Jalen Scott unblocked on that play, and now it's going to make it a third and long.
Yeah, he lost 5 yards on that play there. Ball spotted back at the 35.
So it looks like a timeout has been called on the play on the field. An official timeout. There was a football on the field in the end zone. Looks like it was from the fumble earlier. Can't believe it was there that long.
Somebody wasn't paying attention.
So third and long coming up here, most likely going to be a pass play, but we don't really know much about Dula at quarterback.
No, this is our first time seeing him, but I want to say he's had some time playing this year because Tucker did miss some games due to injury.
Dula's going to get a quick screen pass to number 20. He's going to cut up to the left and is met at about the 27, number 20 being Tay Dula, so Dula to Dula. We've seen the Surratt connections, connection with the brothers, and now we see the Dula brothers go at it with a connection.
And they look like they're going to mark him at the 28-yard line. They're going to mark him down to 28, so give him a gain of 7.
And both of the Dulas are sophomores, so this West Caldwell team is pretty young. T.J. McClain on the stop. That's one tackle closer to getting the record.
They need 5 more for the record.
So fourth down coming up, 4th and 11. As it's going to be shotgun formation once again. Dula, Francis, and Kunkel to the left. As Dula is going to drop back, going to throw. And it's off the hands of Dula, Tay Dula. And it's going to be a turnover on down. So Wes Caldwell cannot take advantage of the fumble by Sage Surratt, and East Lincoln will take the ball back at their own 29-yard line. A huge stop by the East Lincoln Mustangs defense.
Yes, it was. Again, this defense does not get the credit that they deserve this season, being big-time stoppers there. And again, bend but don't break, and basically holding West Caldwell after that turnover.
So penalties hurt West Caldwell on that drive as well. So Mustangs trying to get something going here. They've had already caused 2 turnovers. Surratt going to take the snap, going to hand it off to Colton Banks. He goes for the middle. He's got a lot of room and is stopped at about the 38-yard line. Looks like about a gain of 9 on the play.
I think they're going to mark him at the 37. So I give him a gain of 9.
Okay,
sets up a 2nd and 1.
Trash Rat's going to have a quarterback keeper this time. He's going to go down the sideline of West Caldwell and is pushed out of bounds by Tay Dula at about the 42-yard line. That's going to be good enough for a Walker Pharmacy of Newton first down.
Yeah, they're going to knock out of bounds by Tay Dula there. The 43-yard line.
It'll be 1st and 10 Mustangs from their own
42-yard line, excuse me. And give Chaz a gain of 5 on this
Chaz
first carry tonight.
Going to pass. He passes it to Sage. Sage makes a nice cut. He cuts through another defender. He's at the 30-yard line and is tackled finally as West Caldwell finally gets their hands on him by Taylor Kunkel.
29-yard reception there for Sage Surratt. And it's going to be spotted down at the 29 of West Caldwell.
And that's good enough for Nutter Walker Pharmacy. Newton first down. Mustangs moving the ball down the field. And there's a flag now on the field. Don't know what it is, but we're about to get the call here. But it looks like it could be against West Caldwell here. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Warriors.
So add on 15 yards. So now add 15 yards and look like West Caldwell will start to shoot themselves in the foot.
Yeah. Not helping themselves.
So now that'll give the Mustangs the ball there at the West Caldwell 14-yard line.
Got to be careful there if you're West Caldwell from
trying to keep your composure, yeah.
Yeah. And, well, that's good enough for Walker Pharmacy
Newton
first down.
It is.
And change waiting to move. This will be a big touchdown here for the Mustangs after two turnovers on their first two drives to get a touchdown here.
Update between Kings Mountain and Chase. Kings Mountain leading Chase 7-0.
It's going to be a fake to Banks. Chaz throwing it, and it's caught. He's hit hard. Trevor Childers.
Yeah, and he is stopped by number 23, and that's Elijah Brooks. And Childers is marked down at the 10-yard line, so give him a gain of 4 on the reception.
But you cannot say enough about how he held on to the ball in that
yes,
play.
Yes, he did.
Hard hit there by Brooks. Surratt takes the snap. He's looking to Sage in the end zone, and it is no good, but there's a flag on the field about that area. That might go against Sage.
No touchdown given on the play, and the flag is
there. Pass interference against Sage there.
The offensive pass interference, so Mark bring him back 15 yards.
Didn't look like it looked close. He might have had the touchdown there. Not really sure. It looked like he bobbled it, but now East Lincoln kind of hurts himself there with the pass interference, and that'll move them back to the West Caldwell 25-yard line.
So it's going to set up a second and 20 here. Mustangs going 2x2.
Chaz going to do a screen pass to Cameron Dollar. Cameron Dollar gets it. He's across the 20. He's got a lot of room to the left side. He's at the 10 and near the first down, and it's forced out of bounds at about the 8-yard line.
And there to make the stop is number 10, Bishop Kidd. And they're going to mark him down at the 8-yard line. So give him a gain. Give him a gain of 18 there.
So a third and short coming up for the Mustangs. That's one thing we've seen from the Mustangs all year is those short passes seem to work really well for them to get in big gains. Chasrat with quarterback keeper this time. Spin moves, and he is in the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Surratt with the 8-yard TD run.
So after two turnovers on their first two drives, the Mustangs move it down the field and score a touchdown. Much needed touchdown for the Mustangs to get the momentum going their way. And now Blake Strupp coming out here to attempt the point after. As the first point after hit the uprights and was missed by West Caldwell. And the kick is up, and it is good. So with 3:52 left in the first quarter on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, it is now East Lincoln 7, West Caldwell 6. We'll be back right after this.
It's time to power up with Buddy's Home Furnishings Power Up Package. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you with same-day delivery. Rent an Ashley Mayer sectional with your choice of an Ashley Quindon or a Kenmore washer and dryer or a 55-inch LG smart LED TV, only $37.99 per week. Find out how you can own it all in less than a year. And you're approved up to $2,500 in store credit at Buddy's Home Furnishings, 1116 East Main Street in Lincoln.
Back here at David Clark Stadium, home of the East Lincoln Mustangs, as the Mustangs now have their first lead of the ball game, as they are currently up on the West Caldwell Warriors 7-6.
And so our score update from around the area, end of the first quarter, St. Stephen 6, South Caldwell 0. And Thomas Jefferson leading Bessemer City 14-0 at the end of the first quarter.
Yeah, Thomas Jefferson's been a part of that three-team race against Community School Davidson and Pine Lake Prep, who is currently playing Cherville tonight.
Yes, they are.
And Strupp about to kick it off once again as Brooks and number two, who's getting the return here, Deshaun Francis. Sean Francis gets it about the 5-10-yard line. He's going to be stopped at about the 32-yard line. So the Titus Tucker West Caldwell Warriors offense will take the field as Caleb Dula, the quarterback now, who has played, as you said, a couple times this year.
And they are spotting the ball at the 32-yard line.
they're going to have it at shotgun. Or no, pit. Yes.
Offset pistol. All pistol.
France is going to motion. It's going to be handoff to Harper. Harper goes to the right side and is met at the 34-yard line.
Met by number 84, and that's Will Mercer. And he had quite a few tackles last week. And like a gain of one for Harper.
Yeah, Mercer is a biggin. He is 6'5", 230, and he's not a senior. He's only a junior. So he's still got some growing room, I guess.
SD7 score update. Bandys leading Bunker Hill 8-0 at the end of the first quarter. And Bandys is looking for their first win on the season.
Yeah, Bandys has not won a game at all. And Bunker Hill is looking for their first conference win. They've won two games this year. All right, second down and 9 coming up. And it's going to be a sweep to Elijah Brooks. He's at the 35 and is met at about the 37-yard line as he was stopped on the play by number 50, Eli Smith.
Okay, by number 23, Elijah Brooks. Stopped by number 50, Eli Smith.
And they're going to spot him at the 36-yard line. So give him a gain of 3 from Mr. Brooks.
And, another touchdown for Lincoln with only 4 minutes left in the first quarter. They are up against on Newton Conover, 28-0. Those seniors are definitely wanting to play as they got a lot of seniors on that team.
Yes, they are.
So, a 3rd and 6 coming up for the Warriors. Momentum starting to slip for the Warriors here as they need to get this first down. And Dula takes snap, 3-step drop. He's scrambling to the right side, under pressure, and is sacked. Sacked on the field by number 61, Keegan Burke.
Burke with the big stop, and he's going to be spotted back at the 35-yard line. So, give him a loss on the play for Dula.
As one thing that we've been saying, not breaks,
yes.
This defense has gotten better as the year goes along. I think it was like that last year
It was like that last year. As they got made deeper and deeper in the season, the defense got better and better. And back beat for the Mustangs is Cameron Dollar, and doing the punting duties is number – oh, we have a flag?
Look.
And –
False start there, so back them up 5 yards.
So that means better field position. We're presuming that's going to be better field position for the Mustangs as punting is Zach Clay.
And it's a high punt, but not very deep. It's going to take a Mustang bounce, and it's going to fall out of bounds at the 47-yard line. So about 23 yards on that punt. And another flag on the play. So, see what this call is.
And another flag thrown. So, two flags now thrown. Looks like it's going to be against the Mustangs here.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Mustangs. Now, move the ball back to the 33-yard line.
And now the Mustangs will have the ball at their own 33-yard line to start the drive instead of having it near the 50-yard line. 1:24 remaining in the first quarter of play here at David Clark Stadium. Mustangs on top 7-6. First down and 10 coming up for the Mustangs. Chasserat hands it off to Colton Banks. Colton Banks gets through the 40-yard line and is stopped at about the
43. Look like they're going to mark with 42. Let's see what it is.
Close to a first down.
They're going to just shot. So give him. Yeah. Get him to the 42. It's just here. Well, 42 and a half. As close as.
Yeah, that's about as close as you can. And now they're going to change it. It's now going to be a Walker Pharmacy.
So
first down.
Give him a gain of 10. Ball's at
43. And Drone is now up 7-0 against Burns with 10:20 left in the first half. Big game there in the SMAC conference. Chaz takes the snap, drops back, looking to Sage once again. Sage met by two defenders and is going to get stopped at about the 44-yard line. That's going to be another Walker Pharmacy of Newton first down.
13 on the reception there for Sage Durant. 13, yes, sir.
And Mustangs moving the ball very quickly. It's going to be a handoff to Colton Bank. And
false start there. Let the line. The lineman got off just a little bit early.
And so this is probably the most we've in a while that we've seen a lot of penalty flags in tonight game this year.
Moving back 5 yards. So sets up a first and 15 now. And score update is Maiden leading West Lincoln 14-0 at the end of the first quarter. And in the first, Hickory leading Fred T. Ford 7-0.
And I believe Hickory's still winless.
Yes, they are.
It's first and 15 for the Mustangs. Chad's going to drop back and is going to throw it to Sage once again, wide open. He's across the 40, across the 35, still on his feet, and is going to be out of bounds.
Going to be spotted down right there at the 31-yard line. Look like this is where they're going to mark him at. So give him a gain of 18.
And it's going to be another Walker Farmer, Steve Newton, first down for the Mustangs coming right up. As I don't think Chaz has thrown it to anyone besides Sage in this game so far.
Cameron Dollar and Trevor Trills with that one catch. Maybe he got right there. Yeah, Cameron Dollar has one catch.
Well, it just seems like a lot to Sage.
Yes.
And it's going to be a fake to Colton Banks. It's going to be a screen pass. Sage almost drops it, bobs it. He's going on his feet. He's at the 20 and is forced out of bounds by Tay Dula.
Right at the 20-yard line. So, but that'll be another first down.
That Walker was close to a horse collar there if it wasn't. So
give him 11 on that pickup.
So another Walker Pharmacy Newton first down. Mustangs going to try to get one more playoff. 12.1 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. They are now in red zone territory. Chaz is going to give the handoff to Colton Banks, and he stopped at about the 16-yard line, and that is going to do it for the first quarter of play here at East Lincoln David Clark Stadium. After one quarter of play on the first Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincolnton scoreboard, it's East Lincoln 7, West Caldwell 6. We'll be back right after this.
X-Plan.
The X-Plan?
Yeah, the X-Plan. Over 3,000 companies across the nation offer the X-Plan to their employees. And if you have the X-Plan, you get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
How do I know?
Well, just ask your employer or check with Crossroads Ford. It's available from companies like Walmart, Temkin, AT&T, Wix, PPG, Big Lots, Food Lion, and more.
I'm checking today.
Ask if you have the X-Plan and get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford. 1775 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Get the X-Plan today.
And back here at David Clark Stadium, as the Mustangs are out on top against the West Caldwell Warriors.
Right now, Chad Surratt is off to, after the fumble on the opening play, he's redeemed himself. He's gone 8-for-8 with 107 yards. His brother has, Sage has caught 6 of those 8 passes so far.
And Chad Surratt currently has 204 touchdowns as he's one step closer to getting the record of most touchdowns in North Carolina high school football history.
And the Mustangs will start as 2nd and 7. They're starting at the 16-yard line.
So Colton Bank has been getting a lot more touches here than he usually does in the first half. Chas Rat going to hand it off to Colton Banks once again. He's going down the left side. He's at the 15 and is going to be met. There.
The West Caldwell defense did a good job stretching them east-west. On the tackle is number 55, and that is
Vada Perkins.
Vada Perkins there.
So a third down coming up.
No gain on that play. He got stretched east-west and was not able to cut it upfield, so no gain on the play for Mr. Banks.
So third and 7 coming up for the Mustangs here into red zone. So it'll be a big play coming up here. West Caldwell, they need to get a stop if they want to keep it a one-score ball game. Chasserat steps back. He's going to throw it deep for Sage. Corner end zone, and it's caught. Touchdown, Mustangs. Nice throw, nice catch to Surratt. Connection strikes again.
16 yards there on the receiver.
And Sage Surratt still in the field, though. He's just congratulating his teammates there, both Quigley and Sage, as Blake Strupp going to attempt another point after here. As a looks like a little problem on the scoreboard right now.
The clock, yeah, I got to get the clock reset.
Yeah, but we'll tell you to score no matter what happens on the PAT, and the kick is up, a booming PAT.
Yeah.
That might have hit a truck there.
Yeah, it did hit a truck there. Blake Strupp hit all he had in that kick.
Yeah, so the scoreboard there is not right, but we'll say on the first Federal Savings Bank of Denver-Lincoln scoreboard, it's East Lincoln 14, West Caldwell 6. We'll take a quick timeout.
Hello, my name's George Smith. I suffer from sleep apnea and decided to do something about it. With a note from my general physician, I went to see Dr. John Cloninger, who made me an oral appliance to wear each night while I sleep. It's an easy appointment, and after receiving the mouthpiece, it has totally changed my life. Suffering from high blood pressure and a lack of sleep, with these appliances, I now feel normal. My blood pressure has come down. My wife has quit fussing at me for snoring so loud, and I'm breathing better. So I strongly urge anyone suffering from sleep apnea to call Dr. John Cloninger's office and make an appointment. It's changed my life, and I know you should let it change yours.
See Dr. John Cloninger III on Doncher Drive in Lincolnton. Phone 704-735-0765.
And back here at David Clark Stadium, as the boys in the press box did a nice job of getting the scoreboard back up and running. As you see there, Mustangs 14, West Caldwell 6. And Warriors about to get another kickoff here. Back deep for the Warriors is number 23, Elijah Brooks, and number 2, Deshaun Francis. And Strupp's kicking off to him. And this one's going to go through Elijah Brooks' legs. Looked a little just like Bill Buckner yeah. in the World Series. And
Didn't play it on the hop.
Yeah, and this is coming from a Red Sox fan here. So, pretty brutal. Speaking of that, the Mets are in the World Series for all you baseball fans. Marty McFly was not right about the Cubs winning the World Series.
Yeah, one of the podcasts I listen to, they have one of the guys that hosts, his co-worker, is a big Mets fan. He calls him Super Mets Fan John, and Super Mets Fan John is very, very, very happy.
Yeah, ironically, the Cubs were eliminated on the same day they were predicted to win the World Series.
So, West Caldwell start here from their own 20-yard line. Next possession.
And, oh, we got some movement. Yeah,
East Lincoln went to a little shift on the defensive line, and right tackle moved early in the play. So, that back them up 5 yards.
As West Caldwell, as the momentum has just been shifted very badly since that second drive where they had penalties, a touchdown was called back on a penalty.
Lincoln having a field day right now at the end of the first, almost 21 seconds remaining in the first quarter. They're up on Newton Conover 36-0.
It's almost going to have a running clock, and they're not even at the end of the first quarter.
Well, they can't run the clock till the second half.
Oh, that is right. I did forget about that. Justin Harper on the carry.
And no gain on the play. He's right back at the 15-yard line, Mr. Harper.
So, second down and 15 or 14 coming up. T.J. McClain with another tackle. That's 4 to go now.
Yeah, fourth. He's 4 away from breaking the school record for tackles. And, ball spotted at the 15-yard line. So, second and 15.
Yeah, Lincolnton in a rout right now against Newton Conover, who did a pretty good job against East Lincoln last week. And West Caldwell, Dula takes a snap under pressure. Going to get it off in time to Elijah Brooks, but a little too much away from Brooks. It's going to make it third and long for the Warriors.
Yeah, Dula was pressured on that play. Coming on the corner blitz was number 2, Nate Curitan there, forcing the pass out a little earlier than expected for Dula.
Yeah, Brooks did have some room, but just Dula didn't get it right to where Brooks was able to get
catch it. And on East Lincoln's on their touchdown play, I noticed linebacker number 55, Vada Perkins, he was a spy on Chad Surratt because he didn't come out of all-out rush for him, trying to play him for the run, and Surratt had plenty of room to hit his brother Sage there going towards the corner.
And, man, another flag against West Caldwell. They're not helping themselves here.
Now they're going to back him up 5 more yards. The ball will be spotted at the 10, so now you're looking at a third and 20.
And an update on Titus Tucker. He has his shoulder pads off, and he has his left leg in a Gatorade cooler, so it doesn't look like he's going to be returning.
No, maybe look like it may be an ankle injury. Sorry, sad to see that.
Yeah, and that's going to affect him long term for sure. Fumble on the snap.
And let's see. Quarterback fell back on. He fell down on the ball. Caleb Dula, But it's going to be – he lost yards. It's going to be spotted back at the 7-yard line. They're going to spot the ball at.
Yeah, and you could see East Lincoln going to probably try and get a blocked punt here. This would be big if they do.
So a loss of 3 on the play. And the ball's at the 7-yard line.
Zach Clay going to be punting it once again for the Warriors. Cameron Dollar back deep as well once again.
Great field position for the Mustangs. And it is. And it is a poor punt. And the ball's going to roll dead there at the 34-yard line.
Yeah, a little close call there. I thought that ball was going to hit Cameron Dollar.
On the foot, yeah. He's just standing there. May roll and touch his foot.
So, great field position for the Mustangs.
27 yards there on the punt.
Yeah, Clay doesn't really seem to get the distance, but he seems to get the hang time.
And gets the bounce as well.
Yeah, that is another good thing, but you never can really predict what the bounce is going to be.
No, you can't.
That's just luck.
Yeah, ask Michigan fans about the bounce, or not even the bounce.
It was a toss, really.
Yeah.
Chasseret takes a snap, going to hand it off to Colton Banks. He's got a lot of room, and is going to be met at about the 28-yard line. So looks like a gain of 7 or 8 on the play. Colton Banks is getting large chunks of yardage here in this ball game so far.
Yes, he is. They're going to mark him at the 28. Give him a gain of 6 on the play. 27, so ball's give him gain of 7 on the play.
And Coach Mike Bias giving the play call to Chaz. Mustangs are no huddle. Sage all by himself. And Chaz going to drop back. Looking for Sage, a big throw. And it is caught. Touchdown.
Got both feet in the end zone. Only need one in high school. And that is a 27-yard touchdown strike from Chaz to his little brother Sage. Second TD of the night for both.
Man, when that thing came off of Chaz's hand, I thought that was way too much, but it was just enough. And Sage, he got both feet in. That would have been an NFL touchdown.
Yes, it was. They're at the back of the end zone.
So now 206 for Chaz Surratt for touchdowns in a high school career. He is now only 10 touchdowns away from tying Chris Leek's record. And Strupp coming out to do the point after once again. Cameron Dollar on the hold as always. Takes a snap. PAT is up. It's not hitting the truck this time, but it's good. And with 8:40 remaining in the first half on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, it's East Lincoln 21, West Caldwell 6.
Wake up, everybody. Just kidding. You can snooze thanks to Mickey D's new all-day breakfast menu. It's my favorite meal of the day. And when you're in the mood, it's available now. Anytime, so come through. Hot cakes and sausage, other chain, it don't stop. Golden hash brown served all day, round the clock.
Introducing McDonald's new all-day breakfast menu, featuring a savory sausage biscuit with egg sandwich. Get the special taste at breakfast time at a time that works for you.
Right around the clock.
Menu items vary. Deliciousness doesn't.
Back here at David Clark Stadium as the Mustangs. Slow start with first two drives and turnovers, but ever since then, they've been rolling as usual.
Yes, they have been. After turnovers on their first two possessions, but now they've got the Novocaine is kicked in. Let's say give it time. It'll kick in. It's kicked in, and they're now up 21-6.
And as things are getting better for the Mustangs, things are just getting worse for the Warriors. As first you lose your quarterback on the first play from scrimmage, and you just can't get anything going now. And a flag on the field. It's going to be moved back 5 yards on the kickoff as it's offsides on the Mustangs. So just moving back 5 yards. Back deep for the Warriors once again is Elijah Brooks and Deshaun Francis. Francis has replaced Titus Tucker on the kickoff return.
Yes, he is.
And a big one down in Mecklenburg County is North Meck is currently over Vance 14-7 at halftime.
Offside call moves the ball back 5 yards. Mustangs will kick again.
It's a squib kick. It's going to bounce at the.
And it's touched.
It's touched by number two, Deshaun Francis, and he touched the ball out of bounds right at the 24-yard line.
And he is regretting that, because that one would have been out of bounds, and they would have had the ball at their own 35-yard line. So
he basically lost them 11 yards.
Yeah, big break for the Mustangs. So let's see if West Caldwell can get their offense going here, as they have 6 points on the board, but the East Lincoln Mustangs defense has allowed no points, as the touchdown came on a fumble recovery for a touchdown.
Yes.
As that was recovered by Taylor Kunkel of the Warriors. It's going to be a pitch out to Tristan Harper. He is looks like he got a loss.
Maybe they stopped his forward progress at the line of scrimmage. So
it might have been a loss, I think.
Yeah, they're going to keep. Yeah, going to mark him back at the 23. Mark area by number six. Yeah, he loses a yard.
So, 2nd and 11 coming up here for the Warriors.
And the last four carries for Harper has been negative 5 yards, 1 yard, no yard, and now loss of a yard.
We're going to give it to Harper once again. He's
flag
the field.
Flag on play, so maybe blown dead before the play started.
It looks like it's against the Warriors, no offside.
Maybe the wide receiver not up on the line of scrimmage there, so we'll back him up.
Yeah, Deshaun Francis was pleading his case. He's pleading his case to the head referee right now. He looks very furious, as he's got to be careful.
Yeah, he's got to be careful. Usually don't see players going directly to the referee like that.
Yeah, well, and West Caldwell already has a on sports 15-yard penalty. He's furious right now. They got to be careful over there. Second and 16 now for the Warriors. He's going to hand off to Harper once again. Harper is going to gain yardage this time.
He's met by a host of Mustangs, and looks like they're going to mark him up to the 25-yard line.
Yeah, he gets the yardage back, but it's still going to be a third and long situation for the Warriors.
We'll spot him at the 25, so give him a gain of 7.
So third and nine, yes, coming up for the Warriors. Dula under center. Take snap's going to be a handoff to Harper once again. He's going to cut out to that, and he's met in the backfield.
Yeah, first contact made.
Sage
are right there coming in on the tackle. And it looks like they're going to get him back to the line of scrimmage, so no gain on the play.
So three plays on this drive, no yardage gained. Mustangs defense doing a great job of holding the Warriors. As Cameron Dollar going to be back deep to return the punt. That is if he doesn't call a fair catch or it doesn't have isn't a small punt.
Again, doing the punting duties is Zach Clay. And another short kick and it's going to take a Mustang bounce and bounces back towards the. Look at the 36, 37-yard line. See where they're going to spot the ball
at. It looks about the 37.
Yeah, they're going to spot the ball at 37. So 12-yard punt.
So, Jason, I think you put the jinx on the punter there. You said it's taking West Caldwell bounces. Now it's taking East Lincoln bounces.
Yes, it is.
So about nothing going West Caldwell's way now in this game.
No, it's not. Update, St. Stephen's leading South Caldwell now 18-7. Surprise score right there.
And Maiden is leading West Lincoln 21-7. Of course, West Lincoln no longer playoff eligible after too many ejections in the past 2 weeks. First and 10. Snap goes for Chess Red. It's still bobbling, and I believe Red got it.
He falls on it. Yeah, he's going to fall back at the 46-yard line.
Yeah, close call there for the Mustangs. Almost their third turnover.
Yeah, that's going to be a 9-yard loss.
We still got time to make it up, but not the way you want to start any drive.
8-yard loss, ball at the 45.
And Colton Banks is now going to be on the right of Chaz Surratt. Surratt takes a snap. Another one of those bobbled snaps. Surratt gets it. He's going to scramble as he's at the 40 and goes out of bounds at about the 37-yard line.
He's still going to have to tuck the ball away. He's holding it out like a loaf of bread right now.
Yeah, he's got to be careful as that caused the first turnover and the only touchdown of the game for the Warriors.
Like he got 37, so like
got most of the yardage.
Back to the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah, it's going to make it third and 11.
Actually, going to put a 38.
Scored at halftime, Kings Mountain in a low-scoring game against Chase, 10-0.
So, yeah, ball spotted 38-yard line, so gain of 7 on that play.
Bice getting the play call out there to Chaz. Chaz takes a snap. He gets it perfectly this time. He's going to roll out to his right, throws it to Cameron Dollar, and he's still on his feet at the 20, the 15, the 10, cuts up, and he's still on his feet at the 5. Touchdown, Mustangs! Amazing footwork, and running by Cameron Dollar.
His second reception of the night, first TD on the night.
38.
So, Rat, 11 of 11, passing with 3 touchdowns.
As the Mustangs are running away with this ball game now. Chaz's third touchdown pass. He's got 4 total touchdowns in this ball game. And the kick is up, and it is good. So on the first Federals of Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, it is now East Lincoln 28, West Caldwell 6. We'll be back right after this.
It's Christmas Open House November 6th and 7th at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center on the Reevesville Road in Lincoln. All Christmas items will be on sale. Plus, enjoy free refreshments and register to win door prizes. Christmas Open House hours will be from 8 a.m. till 5:30 p.m. on Friday, November 5th, 8 a.m. till 5 on Saturday, November 6th, and 1 till 6 p.m. on Sunday, November 7th. The Christmas Open House at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center, 969 Reevesville Road in Lincolnton.
Back here at David Clark Stadium, home of the Mustangs, as the Mustangs are starting to roll away from the Warriors. They are up 28-6 on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincolnton scoreboard. Chas Ratz getting in his mojo now.
Chas Ratz's last 3 passes all touchdowns, 17 yards, 27 yards, and 38 yards. Surratt there, he's no incompletion so far, knock on wood. I don't want to be the jinx again. He's 11 of 11 so far passing the first half of 3 touchdowns.
100 completion percentage right now.
Yeah, 100%, yep.
Strupp out the kick once again, and Brooks and Francis out back deep for the Warriors.
Set the kick for the Mustangs, number 20, Blake Strupp.
And a big booming kick. This one's going to be taken by Deshaun Francis in the 3-yard line. He's going to be at the 15-20, finds a big hole. He's at the 25-30. He's still on his feet at the 40. The 45, he's going to be stopped at the 45.
Stopped on the play there by number 15 with the touchdown-saving tackle, and that's Connor Fail on the tackle. They're going to spot Francis down at the 46-yard line.
It's a good field position for the Warriors, as that was almost a deja vu for the Mustangs.
From last week. Good 43 yards on the return there for Mr. Francis.
And Warriors going back in shotgun formation. They got to get something going if they want to be in this ball game right here. Now down 28-6. Going to be a handoff to Harper. Harper is going to get some yardage here, but not much.
I think they're going to spot him there at the 48-yard line. So give him a gain of 2.
Yeah, Harper, those first 2 drives, I believe, got some yardage. But
yeah,
the last few times he's been able to get the ball, it's been either a loss or
– at this first 4 carries, he had 27 yards. And then since then, he had lost minus 5, 1 yard, no yard, minus 1, gain of 7, and now gain of 2.
Second and 8 coming up. It's going to be another handoff to Harper. He's going to get to midfield.
Yeah, I think forward progress stops. They're going to spot him at the 49, just shot mid.
But there is a flag on the field holding against the Warriors. As this, this lot of penalties in tonight's ballgame.
Against the Warriors.
ball going to be spotted back at the 40-yard line. So they got to the 50. So give them a gain of two on the carry and then mark the penalty.
So now the ball spotted at their own 40-yard line. It's going to make it about a second and 17, I believe. Dula going to take the snap, fake it to Harper. He's going to throw it to, I believe, Elijah Brooks. Couldn't really tell who it was on the other side of the field. About a gain of two or three. It's going to make it a third and long coming up.
That is Elijah Brooks on the reception.
Darren Martin on the stop for the Mustangs.
And they're going to spot the ball there at the 43-yard line, so give him a gain of three on that.
So West Caldwell had great field position to start the drive as now they're in danger of going three and out once again. Dula's going to drop back under some pressure. He's going to throw it deep to number 14. And
oh, what a play by Blake Strupp there to knock the ball away. Strupp there jumping up and knocking the ball away with his right hand.
That was amazing there. Yeah, you deserve to get some high fives from your teammate after a play like that.
Might have to check Mr. Strupp's vertical leap after that one.
Yeah, that was pretty amazing there. I think he was trying to Odell it there.
Yeah. He knocked it down. He did his job.
So another three and out for the Warriors offense as a punting team coming out once again. Dollar back deep to return to punt with 16 Zach Clay, but Cameron has not returned a punt so far.
And remember, East Lincoln gets the ball to start the second half.
And oh, it's blocked.
Punt is blocked, and then it's recovered by number 49. And that is that's Darren Martin on a blocked punt recovery and taking it in for a touchdown.
And this is the loudest I've heard this place tonight. David Clark Stadium's going crazy.
35 yards on the return there for Darren Martin. And the punt was blocked by, I didn't catch the number who blocked it.
So things just getting worse for the Warriors and things getting – and it's just getting better for the Mustangs.
And
Strupp now point after once again. And snap kick up. And it is good. So now on the first Federal Savings Bank of Denver-Lincolnton scoreboard, Mustangs are now up 35-6 over the West Caldwell Warriors. We'll take a quick timeout, and we'll be back here at East Lincoln.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Back here at David Clark Stadium as the Mustangs continue to pull away from the Warriors. They now lead 35-6 with 3:19 left in the first half. And the Warriors will be receiving a kick once again. Deshaun Francis and number four, Fabian Ellaby, will be returning the kickoff.
And that punt was blocked by Jalen Scott. Number one, Jalen Scott coming there and blocked it.
So it was a blessing in disguise that Blake Strupp did not intercept that ball there.
Yes.
And who knows, with the way this Mustangs defense has been holding the Warriors offense, they could get another three and out here, and the Mustangs could score one more touchdown before going into halftime, and they will be getting the kickoff, returning it in the next half as this ball's going out of bounds. That one went all the way to the track at about the 16-yard line. As a scorer of the Big South, the Stuart Kramer Storm big game against Hunter Huss, they are currently leading 14-6 with a half minute left in the second quarter.
Again, that matchup is for playoff seeding for that number one 2A seed there in the Big South. You get that number one 2A seed, you get a home playoff game. Stuart Kramer is trying to make the playoffs for the first time in school history.
Stuart Kramer has two conference wins already.
Hello, West Caldwell is elected to have East Lincoln kick off again tonight.
The Warriors better hope.
They want their return man, Mr. Francis, to get another opportunity there at this last kickoff return.
Yeah, kickoff returns, we've seen West Caldwell return a kickoff for a touchdown. That was against Newton, but that was Titus Tucker.
Yep, I was looking for him again. I don't see him on the bench anymore. Well, sitting on the bench icing his ankles.
They may have taken him to the locker
room. Yeah, they may have gone to the locker room.
As I do see, the West Caldwell locker room door is open. So maybe he went in there a little bit early before halftime. Mm-hmm. All of his helmet's down there on the sideline.
Evans scored. South Iredell now leading North Lincoln at the half, 36-0.
That South Iredell team is probably going to be the favorite. Is probably going to win the conference unless they somehow lose a game.
Homecoming night at Burns right now. They're tied at the half with Drone, 7-7.
That is a big game for both teams that are both trying to look to make it to the playoffs. Drone's got a pretty good squad this year. And Deshaun will take it at about the 18-yard line. He's going to go all the way to the other side of the field. Cuts up and slips.
And he's going to slip down at the 23, 24-yard lines.
So, man, West Caldwell declines the penalty, and that hurts them there.
Yeah, they're going to mark him at the 23-yard line.
Well, Deshaun Francis is really getting mad. He had that penalty on himself that he's arguing to the refs earlier. And then on the last kickoff, the ball was going to go out of bounds, but he touched it.
Yeah, two kickoffs before that. Yeah, he did. And
it's been a rough night for West Caldwell, and it's also been a very rough night for Deshaun Francis.
And West Caldwell's got to try to sustain a long drive because, remember, East Lincoln starts the second half with possession.
And they're going to give the ball to Elijah Brooks on the carry. He's going to be met at about the line of scrimmage, maybe a gain of one, if anything.
Yeah, number 50, Eli Smith there making contact. And look like they're going to spot the ball at the they're going to give him a yard.
Yeah, it looks like they are going to give him a yard.
So, gain of one for Mr. Brooks. Ball be at the 24-yard line.
And now the Warriors going back into the spread shotgun formation. And a bad snap. It's through Dula's hands. He's going to fall on it.
And he's fall back down at the 10-yard line. So, give him a loss of 14.
Oh, and no, this ain't good for the Mustangs. Trevor Childers down as, ooh, this is terrible here. Looks like it's his knee. This is big, bad news for the Mustangs.
And as they take an injury timeout, we'll take a break with 2:32 remaining in the first half. It's East Lincoln leading the West Caldwell 35-6 on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln's scoreboard.
Here's some good policy from your local independent agent and auto owner's insurance. When you insure your home and car with us, you receive a multi-policy discount. And when you add auto owner's life insurance, you get a special discount on your home and car insurance. Auto owner's insurance will save you money on all of the insurance you already have. Now that's good policy. Auto owner's insurance, the no problem people.
Your local auto insurance agency is East Lincoln Insurance Agency on Highway 60 North in Denver. Give them a call at 704-483-3222.
A huge sigh of relief here at David Clark Stadium as Trevor Childers is able to walk under his own power. Looks like he got tripped up by the turf a little bit and fell down and maybe twisted his ankle. But, that was a close call there.
Yes, it was. But now it sets up a third and 23 because that was a loss of 14 there on that bad snap.
And the Mustangs are going to take a timeout.
Yeah, they're going to take a timeout with 2:32.
And we'll take a quick timeout here as we're taking a timeout on the field. You are currently listening to the Lincoln County SD7 Game of the Week on KTC Broadcasting and LincolnCounty.com.
It's hard to believe First Federal Savings Bank has been serving this area for over 75 years. It's because of local people working and living right here in the community they serve. And they believe in giving back to the community by supporting our local schools, charities, and nonprofits. Services include checking accounts, savings, money markets, CDs, mobile banking, and online banking, with locations in Lincoln, Bogart City, Denver, and West Lincoln. Online at ffsb-nc.com. An equal housing lender and member FDIC.
Back here at David Clark Stadium as the Mustangs are on top of the Warriors 35-6 on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard. Got a third and long coming up here for the Warriors deep in their own territory.
Yeah, that'd be play being taken off at their own 10-yard line. Baseball update right now, Kansas City Royals now up 2-0 in the bottom second of Toronto Blue Jays.
And if the Royals win tonight, they are headed to the World Series. And Dula going to get a try to get the pass to Harper over Frohn, and it's going to be fourth down. Another three and out for the Warriors offense. Yes.
And again, East Lincoln, they've done it so many times this season, score just before halftime and then score to start the second half, and they do get the second half kickoff. Remember, last punt attempt was blocked there by number one. That was Jalen Scott on the block and then returned for a touchdown by Darren Martin. So we'll see if they call the punt block again.
Cameron Dollar back deep if the punt can get to him. He has not returned a punt at all today. Low snap. They get it off this time. Cameron Dollar's yelling Peter as taking a Warrior bounce.
And it's going to bounce down at the 44-yard line.
And now with 3:45 remaining in the second quarter, it's Lincolnton 43, Newton Conover nothing. Newton Conover just can't seem to get nothing done against the Wolves.
No, they can't.
And the Mustangs do have a shot of scoring another touchdown here. 2:19, plenty of time for the Mustangs, especially when your quarterback is named Chaz Surratt.
Yes, and we've seen them score in one play from scrimmage, two play from scrimmage. It doesn't matter how much time. They don't need much time to get a score.
It's first and 10. Chaz takes snap, going to get a swing pass to Colton Banks. Colton's going to get out of bounds at about the
back,
four.
Look like he'll get back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah. So nothing going on that play there for the Mustangs. So maybe we lost a tad bit there.
Yeah, they're gonna mark it back at the 45. So give them a loss of one.
So rare no gain for the Mustangs as Trevor Childers back on the field. Glad to see him back out, going in motion. They're going to fake it to Colton Banks. Surratt looking deep towards Saitrat. It's caught by Saitrat. He's got two defenders on him, still moving, and is stopped at the 2, maybe the 1 yard line.
And just inside, just short of the goal line.
And that is a Walker Pharmacy Newton first down.
And they're going to spot the ball down at the 2 yard line, so give him 43 yards on that reception.
So a big throw by Chaz Surratt once again to his brother Sage, as they have connected a lot tonight.
Chaz, 236 yards passing, 13 of 13.
It's going to be another pass, a bullet to Nick Quigley, touchdown Mustangs. And don't forget about Nick Quigley.
His first catch of the night.
Yeah, and that was a bullet there, throwing a heater, Chaz was.
Now Chaz 14 of 14, 238 yards, four touchdown passes.
And it's hard to believe looking at the score now that the Warriors were up 6-0 early in the game.
Yes, it is.
Strupp out to attempt the point after once again. Cameron Dollar holding for him. And snap is up. And kick is up, and it is good once again. So with 1:45 remaining in the first half of play here at David Clark Stadium, on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, it's now East Lincoln 42, West Caldwell 6. We'll be back right after this quick commercial.
The new Coyote 3510 tractor is now in stock at Weston Sales in Vail. It's what you've been waiting for, a 34-horsepower Coyote tractor for only $17.9. And now you can take $2,500 off all Coyote DK Series tractors, plus get a free loader on all Coyote CK Series tractors, and buy a new Coyote UTV and get 0% financing. Come on in now for all the details at Weston Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail, online at westonsales.com.
I haven't four touchdowns.
And back here at David Clark Stadium, as we are a minute 45 remaining here in the first half, Mustangs now on top 42-6.
East Lincoln 42 unanswered points right now.
You don't really see it that often.
No.
as the last touchdown, a 2-yard touchdown pass from Chad Surratt to Nick Quigley. Quigley getting in on the action for the Mustangs offense.
Yeah, his first catch of the night, and what an impressive one for a 2-yard touchdown.
And Blake Strupp going to squib it this time, and the call catches the Warriors off guard. And it looks like
he's picked up by number 20.
Tay Dula, he's got some running room. He's at across the 40 and is going to be stopped by a handful of Mustangs at about the 45-yard line.
And West Caldwell will start their next possession there at the 45-yard line. Yep.
So now with a minute 35 remaining in the first half, Caleb Dula and the rest of the Warriors offense going to try to get something going, which they really haven't been able to do so tonight. And Caleb was going to be all by himself in the backfield. And Francis going in motion. It's going to be
legit sweep to Francis. He makes one defender miss and gets back. Maybe going to gain a yard. It looks like going to spot him at the 46-yard line.
Stopped on the play by number 24, Dalton Salerno. Dalton Salerno.
Give Mr. Francis a game of one on the play.
And time's running off, as I think that's what the Warriors are wanting to do, is just let that clock go down. Yeah. They don't want to let the Mustangs have another try here, but, you know, Mustangs could call these timeouts. They got two remaining.
Yeah, they have two remaining here in this half. Who knows if they get a stop here.
It's going to be a handoff to Harper. He's got some room on the right side. He's going to get a first down and more. And is
going to feel like they're going to stop him right there at the 40 of East Lincoln.
So, Walker Pharmacy, Newton first down for the Warriors. Yeah.
Give him a gain of 14 on that play.
So, no three and out for the Warriors, as they could have an opportunity to score here if they can move the ball down the field. That is a huge if, though, for the Warriors. Warriors trying to hurry up here. It's 30 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Caleb Dula with Harper in the backfield. It's going to be another handoff to Harper. He's across the 35 to 30, and he's still on his feet. He's got a first down and a little bit of more yardage. He's going to be stopped at the 26.
Yeah, they're going to spot him down at the East Lincoln 26-yard line. So give him another 14 on the carry.
So another Walker Pharmacy of Newton first down has 15.6 seconds remaining. I believe West Caldwell still has a couple timeouts.
Yeah, they have three. They have all three of theirs.
So they're not calling any timeouts. They need to get the play running. It's going to be a pass. And Dula looking deep. And it is intercepted
by number one, and that's Jalen Scott with the interception. Did he drop the ball?
Well, either way, that'll do it for the first half of play here at East Lincoln, as the Mustangs are in control on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, 42-6 over the West Caldwell Warriors. We'll be back after a couple timeouts from our sponsors.
It's time to book your Christmas party now. And there's no better place in our area than Homestead's Grill and Tap House in Lincoln, with two banquet rooms available with accommodations up to 125. Plus, they do on- and off-site caterings such as wedding rehearsal dinners, birthdays, showers, and more. Check out the NFL Sunday Ticket, plus all-you-can-eat ribs, wings, and salad bar Friday and Saturdays for $19.99. And try the new US 1 short rib burger for only $9.49. Homestead's Grill and Tap House, 357 North Generals Boulevard in Lincoln, and coming in November, a new additional location in Denver.
Get the cutting edge. Get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower that raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best. Cut with a Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700.
It's the end of the season tire blowout sale at Full Throttle Power Sports in Gastonia.
Michelin Pilot Power Tires start at $99.99, and Continental Motion Tires start at $75. Plus, get end-of-the-season deals on the remaining Yamaha watercraft. Plus, great motorcycle deals like a 2015 Yamaha R3 for $49.90 and the new 2015 Yamaha FZ6R for $69.89. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 off I-85 at 100 Indian Walk in Lowell. Online at ncfullthrottle.com. It's the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln. Get $1,000 in rebates on select Kubota tractors, plus zero money down, zero financing for 60 months. Offer good on the Kubota L Series and the Kubota BX Series tractors. But hurry, offer in soon. Don't miss the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln, 3636 East Highway 27 in Lincoln. Online at KubotaofLincoln.com.
It's time to power up with Buddy's Home Furnishings Power Up Package. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you with same-day delivery. Rent an Ashley Mayer sectional with your choice of an Ashley Quindon bedroom set or a Kenmore washer and dryer or a 55-inch LG smart LED TV. Only $37.99 per week. Find out how you can own it all in less than a year. And you're approved up to $2,500 in store credit at Buddy's Home Furnishings, 1116 East Main Street in Lincoln.
Hey, David, do you have the X-Plan?
The X-Plan?
Yeah, the X-Plan. Over 3,000 companies across the nation offer the X-Plan to their employees. And if you have the X-Plan, you get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
How do I know?
Well, just ask your employer or check with Crossroads Ford. Walmart, Temkin, AT&T, Wix, PPG, Big Lots, Food Lion, and more.
I'm checking today.
Ask if you have the X-Plan and get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford. 1775 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Get the X-Plan today.
Hello, my name's George Smith. I suffer from sleep apnea and decided to do something about it. With a note from my general physician, I went to see Dr. John Cloninger, who made me an oral appliance to wear each night while I sleep. It's an easy appointment, and after receiving the mouthpiece, it has totally changed my life. Suffering from high blood pressure and a lack of sleep, with these appliances, I now feel normal. My blood pressure has come down. My wife has quit fussing at me for snoring so loud, and I'm breathing better. So I strongly urge anyone suffering from sleep apnea to call Dr. John Cloninger's office and make an appointment. It's changed my life, and I know you should let it change yours.
See Dr. John Cloninger III on Doncha Drive in Lincoln. Phone 704-735-0765.
Wake up, everybody, just kidding. You can snooze thanks to Mickey D's new all-day breakfast menu. It's my favorite meal of the day, and when you're in the mood, it's available now. Anytime, so come through. Hot cakes and sausage on the chain, it don't stop. Golden hash brown served all day, round the clock.
Introducing McDonald's new all-day breakfast menu, featuring a savory sausage biscuit with egg sandwich. Get the special taste at breakfast time at a time that works for you.
Right around the clock.
Menu items vary. Deliciousness doesn't.
And we are at halftime here at David Clark Stadium, home of the Mustangs, as the Mustangs are out on top 42-6. As Jason, what are some of the stats for tonight's game?
Well, for East Lincoln, they trailed. They first two drives, they had turnovers. Fumble by Chastrat in the first carry. Got hit from behind, carrying the ball loosely in his left hand, and it was popped out. And it was returned for a touchdown by Taylor Kunkel, for 28 yards. And in the next possession, Save Surratt on a reception, gets hit from behind, gets hit pretty nice, and ball pops up. And it's returned for a touchdown, but then it's called back on the penalty. So East Lincoln Trail 6-0 after the first two possessions. And they've gone on a 42 unanswered points. And leading the way, of course, is Chance Surratt. Passing-wise, I have him at 14-14 for 238 yards and four touchdowns in the first half. Rushing rushing-wise for the Mustangs, leading rusher right now is Colton Banks. He has 5 carries for 29 yards, and then Chaz himself has 5 carries for 14 yards. And doing on the receiving end is Sage Surratt with 8 catches, 2 touchdowns for 174 yards here in the first half.
And while you were talking, Lincolnton got a field goal. They're now up 46-0 as they are going to halftime. Mm-hmm. Running clock. So
yeah, be running clock there to start that second half. And then for West Caldwell, their quarterback, Titus Tucker, first play from scrimmage, he injures his ankle and is done for the rest of the game. And you know, we've seen him take off his pads and had his foot soaking in the cooler of ice. But stepping in is being Tay Dula.
Or Caleb Dula.
Caleb Dula, excuse me. He's come in, and right now Caleb Dula, I have him 2 of 7 passing for 10 yards. And then rushing-wise for West Caldwell, it's been Trustin Harper with 14 carries, 61 yards total. Not been able to move the ball much there. West Caldwell has been on in the first half. Couldn't take advantage of the East Lincoln turnovers, and then the penalties have been – hurting.
Yeah, ever since Tucker went down on that first play from scrimmage, even though they were up 6-0, just offense really hasn't been able to get nothing. And I mean, it's taken a lot of you know, Titus Tucker being the main weapon, the offense seems to be more predictable now because they are just trying to get it to Tucker and hope that to Harper and hope that they can get yardage on the plays. And Mustangs are just doing a good job of stopping them. And even when the Mustangs have turned it over, it has been bend but not break defense.
And their defense has been phenomenal tonight. You know, they've scored, you know, Surratt with his 4 brothers, Sage, 1 to Nick Quigley and 1 to Cameron Dollar. Then you have the punt, you had the punt block, and it was returned by Darren Martin. And then you have the 8-yard touchdown run by Chaz Surratt. So he's accounted for 5 total touchdowns tonight, Chaz has. With 4 in the air.
Also, we want to tell you some scores as a good one in Mount Holly as East Gaston, North Gaston tied at 21. And another big game in the Big South, Forestview has shut out Ashbrook so far 21-0. Kings Mountain still on top of Chase 10-0. So there's some scores around the area.
Again, Lincolnton's at the half now on Newton Conover 46-0. Kings Mountain leading Chase 10-0. Providence Day leading Country Day 14-8. North Met leading Vance 14-7. It's Maiden leading West Lincoln at the half 21-7. Seen the score earlier with South Caldwell, so somewhat surprising there is South Caldwell. Some other Caldwell County scores give Freedom is leading Highbright in 34-0. And then St. Stephen's leading South Caldwell at the half 18-7. So that's the scores for right now. We'll take a break and we'll be back after this timeout.
And you're looking at the East Lincoln. Back right after these commercial breaks.
It's Christmas Open House November 6th and 7th at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center on the Reevesville Road in Lincolnton. All Christmas items will be on sale. Plus, enjoy free refreshments and register to win door prizes. Christmas Open House hours will be from 8 a.m. till 5:30 p.m. on Friday, November 5th, 8 a.m. till 5 on Saturday, November 6th, and 1 till 6 p.m. on Sunday, November 7th. The Christmas Open House at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center, 969 Reevesville Road in Lincolnton.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Here's some good policy from your local independent agent and auto owner's insurance. When you insure your home and car with us, you receive a multi-policy discount. And when you add auto owner's life insurance, you get a special discount on your home and car insurance. Auto owner's insurance will save you money on all of the insurance you already have. Now that's good policy. Auto owner's insurance, the no problem people.
Your local auto insurance agency is East Lincoln Insurance Agency on Highway 60 North in Denver.
Give them a call at 704-483-3222. It's hard to believe First Federal Savings Bank has been serving this area for over 75 years. It's because of local people working in the community they serve. And they believe in giving back to the community by supporting our local schools, charities, and nonprofits. Services include checking accounts, savings, money markets, CDs, mobile banking, and online banking, with locations in Lincoln, Bogart City, Denver, and West Lincoln. Online at ffsb-nc.com. An equal housing lender and member FDIC. The new Coyote 3510 tractor is now in stock at Weston Sales in Vail. It's what you've been waiting for, a 34 horsepower Coyote tractor for only $17,900. And now you can take $2,500 off all Coyote DK Series tractors. Plus, get a free loader on all Coyote CK Series tractors. And buy a new Coyote UTV and get 0% financing. Come on in now for all the details at West End Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail. Online at westendsales.com. It's time to book your Christmas party now. And there's no better place in our area than Homestead's Grill and Tap House in Lincoln, with two banquet rooms available with accommodations up to 125. Plus, they do on- and off-site caterings such as wedding rehearsal dinners, birthdays, showers, and more. Check out the NFL Sunday Ticket, plus all-you-can-eat ribs, wings, and salad bar Friday and Saturdays for $19.99. And try the new US 1 short rib burger for only $9.49. Homestead's Grill and Tap House, 357 North Generals Boulevard in Lincoln, and coming in November, a new additional location in Denver. Get the cutting edge, get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower that raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best, cut with a Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700.
It's the end of the season tire blowout sale at Full Throttle Power Sports in Gastonia. Michelin Pilot Power tires start at $99.99, and Continental Motion tires start at $75. The season deals on the remaining Yamaha watercraft, plus great motorcycle deals like a 2015 Yamaha R3 for $49.90 and the new 2015 Yamaha FZ6R for $69.89. Full Throttle Power Sports. Exit 22 off I-85 at 100 Indian Walk in Lowell. Online at ncfullthrottle.com. It's the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln. Get $1,000 in rebates on select Kubota tractors, plus zero money down, zero financing for 60 months. Offer good on the Kubota L Series and the Kubota BX Series tractors. But hurry, offer in soon. Don't miss the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln, 3636 East Highway 27 in Lincoln. Online at kubotaoflincoln.com.
It's time to power up with Buddy's Home Furnishings Power Up Package. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you with same-day delivery. Rent an Ashley Mayer sectional with your choice of an Ashley Quindon bedroom set or a Kenmore washer and dryer or a 55-inch LG smart LED TV. Only $37.99 per week. Find out how you can own it all in less than a year. And you're approved up to $2,500 in store credit at Buddy's Home Furnishings, 1116 East Main Street in Lincoln. Hey, David, do you have the X-Plan?
The X-Plan?
Yeah, the X-Plan. Over 3,000 companies across the nation offer the X-Plan to their employees. And if you have the X-Plan, you get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
How do I know?
Well, just ask your employer or check with Crossroads Ford. It's available from companies like Walmart, Timken, AT&T, Wix, PPG, Big Lots, Food Lion, and more.
I'm checking today.
Ask if you're over the X-Plan and get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford. 1775 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Get the X-Plan today.
Hello, my name is George Smith. I suffer from sleep apnea and decided to do something about it. With a note from my general physician, I went to see Dr. John Cloninger, who made me an oral appliance to wear each night while I sleep. It's an easy appointment, and after receiving the mouthpiece, it has totally changed my life. Suffering from high blood pressure and a lack of sleep, with these appliances, I now feel normal. My blood pressure has come down. My wife has quit fussing at me for snoring so loud, and I'm breathing better. So I strongly urge anyone sleep apnea to call Dr. John Cloninger's office and make an appointment. It's changed my life, and I know you should let it change yours.
See Dr. John Cloninger III on Doncher Drive in Lincolnton. Phone 704-735-0765.
Still 2-0 Kansas City.
And you heard it from Jason. Still 2-0 Kansas City against Royals, bottom of the third, and they got two runners on base with two outs.
Yeah, two runners on base, first and second, two outs. Some high school scores update. Yeah. I want to say –
as right now, Mustangs and Warriors are both warming up in about the same area. Warriors doing it to the side, Mustangs on the field. About a minute and about 2 minutes away from kickoff.
Yep, no problem.
As both teams are warming up, Jason's back with us.
Sorry about that.
Nah, you're fine.
Yeah. Checking on the record for T.J. McClain. He is at three tackles away from breaking the school record for all-time tackles. But some score updates here. Bandy's leading Bunker Hill right now, 32-10 at the in the third quarter. In the third quarter, also Thomas Jefferson now leading Bessemer City, 21-16. Bessemer's trying to keep afloat in that Southern Piedmont Conference, 1A Conference.
That could help them when it comes to playoff spots, because if they get this win, they get two conference wins, and then they got Cherville and Highland Tech the next 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Now, we told you Lincolnton is up on Newton Conover 46-0 at the half. Here's some stats from that game at the half so far. Lincolnton has 221 yards rushing to Newton Conover's -22. Lincolnton has 216 yards passing to Newton Conover's 195. In total yards, Lincolnton has 437, Newton Conover 173.
And that's only in the first half.
Yes.
And South Iredell scores again against North Lincoln early in the third quarter, as the running clock will now be in effect in South Iredell.
Yes, it will be. And we are one score away from it being in effect here, and it goes into effect there at Lincolnton. And again, Chasterat has accounted for five of the six touchdowns scored tonight. The other six touchdowns was Darren Martin on the block punt return, and Chaz with four touchdowns passing, one rushing, and his brother Sage Surratt with 173 yards receiving, nine catches, and two TDs himself.
Yes, it's been the Surratt show once again. It's hard to believe that they turned the ball over in the first few drives. It's been completely different since that last turnover and the defense got the stop. It's been all Mustangs since then, as we're about ready for kickoff, as the Mustangs will return it since they deferred, as that's going to help them.
That's been their thing. They defer to the second half because they are so good at scoring just before halftime and then starting the second half and scoring on the open possession.
Yeah, I'm always one of those guys that likes to defer. That is, I've never been a coach, so I don't get to make those calls. So West Caldwell about to kick it off once again, and, of course, the kicking duties goes to Zach Clay. We've seen him out here more for punts, as returning it for the Mustangs is number six, Jalen Frazier, a freshman, 5'7", and number 33, is Judd Real, another freshman. So some of the young guys getting in now for the Mustangs. And it's going to be a pooch kick. So it's going to be returned.
Colton Banks.
No, it looks like number two, which is Nate Curitan, the junior, as he's going to be stopped on
the 38-yard line. I think I'm walking down there. Update from Bessemer City. Thomas Jefferson now leading Bessemer City 28-16.
It's Thomas Jefferson to try to have a comfortable lead against the Yellow Jackets. Also in the SPC and another score in that conference, Mountain Island Charter is currently at 34-0 over Greenville Homeschool.
Yes. Ball, they're going to start the drive at the 39-yard line.
Chasserat comes in. He's got five touchdowns tonight. He's eight away from tying Chris Leake's touchdown record, nine from breaking it. Surratt takes a snap. It's going to be a pass to Cameron Dollar in the flats. Cameron Dollar's got some room across the 45, going to be go out of bounds at
right,
the 45.
At the 45, so give him 6 yards on that reception for Mr. Dollar.
It's going to make it a second and six coming up for the Mustangs. Second and four coming up for the Mustangs. So going to the flats is simple yet effective, and it's sometimes
well,
for the Mustangs.
Remember, West Caldwell's been burnt deep, so now they're the short route underneath the zone.
Chaz takes a snap again, and it's going to be fake to Colton Banks. He's under, Trevor Childers. He's going to run it, and about right. He's going all the way to the stands there.
Let me go to mark him out of bounds. Let's see what he marks. They're going to mark him back at the 49. Let's see.
47.
47-yard line. They're going to. So gain of two on the carry for Chaz.
It's going to make it a third and two coming up for the Mustangs. So three and out possibly for the Mustangs here. To start the drive in the first drive of the second half. Chaz takes a snap, going to hand it off to Colton Banks. He's got the first down, and then some more. Breaks through, and he's going to get across the 45 before being stopped.
At the left, they're going to mark him at the 43-yard line of West Caldwell. Okay,
Banks, he doesn't really get the ball as much as some of these other running backs in the area, but when he does, he usually gets big amount of yardage, and he's been getting good chunks of running yardage.
You remember last week, Chasserat had over 20-plus carries last week. I think Coach Byers wants to save him some on his running and let Colton Banks carry the load more.
And they're going to fake it to Banks this time. Chaz going to throw it deep to Cameron Dollar. He had to
pass interference, yeah.
Obvious pass interference there. And it was the ref, the back judge there. You would have thought the side judge would have saw it there because number two, Deshaun Francis, was clearly holding on to Cameron Dollar's jersey.
Yes, he was there. So with that penalty, that does not affect the perfect passing game so far for Chess. Right?
Well, but then again, with Deshaun Francis, you're like, hey, this guy could get a touchdown.
Yeah,
there.
We'd rather give up 15 than 43.
Yeah. So it's a double-edged sword when it comes to that for Deshaun Francis as the run continues. Yeah, it's not been the best night for him or his team.
Ball will be spotted 28 at the penalty.
Chess Rack going to fake it to Colton Banks. He's looking deep once again. Cameron Dollar. Tight covers, but he catches it. Touchdown, Mustangs!
Right over top of Deshaun Francis. Cameron Dahl with the 28-yard touchdown reception. That is touchdown pass number five from Chasserat, and he is one away from tying his county record of six touchdown passes in a game.
Now, I said it's a rough night for Deshaun Francis. It just got rougher as he had real tight coverage on Cameron Dollar, and Cameron Dollar was able to catch the ball and go into the end zone for the touchdown. So make that number 209 for Chasserat when it comes to touchdowns all time. So he is only seven away from tying, eight away from breaking the North Carolina high school record, which is held by Chris Leake. Strip out the PAT. Kick is up, and it is good. So with 10:09 remaining in the third quarter of play on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincolnton scoreboard, it's now East Lincoln 49, West Caldwell 6. We'll be back right after this.
Mm-hmm. Wake up,
everybody, just kidding.
You can snooze thanks to Mickey D's new
all-day
breakfast menu.
Day.
It's my favorite meal of the day, and when you're in the mood, it's available now.
Anytime,
so come through. Hot cakes and sausage, other chain, it don't stop.
Golden hash brown
served all day, round the clock.
Introducing McDonald's new all-day breakfast menu, featuring a savory sausage biscuit with egg sandwich. Get the special taste of breakfast time at a time that works for you.
Right around the clock.
Menu items vary. Deliciousness doesn't.
Back here at David Clark Stadium with 10:09 remaining in the third quarter of play. Mustangs now top 49-6 over the Warriors of West Caldwell.
And Chance Surratt here said that was just touchdown pass number 5 on the night. The county record, which he is tied with, he said last year was 6 in the game. He's tied, I want to say, with Zach Gibson maybe. I can't remember who else has the county record. But tied at 6 touchdown passes is the most in the game for Lincoln County record, which Chaz has tied that record before, and he's one away from tying it again.
And Chaz Surratt's been getting touchdown passes to not only Cameron Dollinger, Sage Surratt, but Nick Quigley, so he's been distributing the ball as well. Kickoff's going to be returned by number 6, Tristan Harper. So he's got some room. He's at the 50, the 45, and is going to be forced out of bounds at the East Lincoln 46. They're saying he's out at the 46-yard line. So a good field position to start their first drive of the second half for the Warriors.
Yeah, starting Mustang territory. And Tristan Harper there picked up the
So Caleb Dula trying to get some offense going at least for the Warriors. They've been able to get nothing really going minus a couple good runs by Harper. They're going to give it to Harper once again. He's going to get across to 45 and is going to be stopped. He's still on his feet, actually, and is finally stopped at about the 41-yard line. So a good gain of 5 there for Harper.
And stopped on the play there by Trevor Childers, and I think they're going to mark him down at the 41. Let's see.
And by the way, Harper is now over 1,000 yards on the year rushing. So
spot the ball at the 42-yard line. Let's give him a gain. Mr. Harper, a gain of 4.
I believe we're now under a running clock here at David Clark Stadium. Second and 5 coming up for the Warriors. As it's going to be a handoff to Harper. It's 2 to 40, maybe a little bit more, but that's about it.
We'll give him a yard to get to the 40-yard line.
As a... Do not see T.J. McLean is on the sidelines, so doesn't look like they're going to get him back in the game as he's still 3 tackles away from becoming the new record holder for most tackles in Mustang history. So third down coming up for the Warriors. It's going to be a handoff to Harper once again. He's going to be tripped up on the play and stopped after a yard.
Again, Trevor Childers there in on the tackle. Gonna spot him down at the 39-yard line.
And I believe West Caldwell is probably going to go for it here. Got nothing really to lose down 49-6. And 4th and 2 coming up here, and it looks like West Caldwell is going to go for it. Most things are probably going to have to look out for a hard snap, hard count here. Hand off to Harper once again. He's going to get the first down. Yes,
he's going to be stopped down at the 35-yard line. Give him a gain of 4 on that carry.
So in Walker Pharmacy of Newton, first down for the Warriors. Been pretty rare occurrence tonight. So Harper pretty much the workhorse now that Tucker's out.
Yes, he is. And score update at the end of the third quarter, St. Stephen's leading South Caldwell 25-14. Again, so a surprise there because in that conference, South Caldwell is 3-1 and St. Stephen's is 1-3. So
Looks like Francis going in motion. They're going to give it to him on the jet sweep. He's going to cut out to the left side and is not – I don't think he's going to make it to the line of scrimmage.
And then he was met by Childers and number 20,
Blake Strupp.
Blake Strupp.
Okay, and number two, Deshaun Francis, but out of bounds by number 20, Blake Strupp.
And they're going to give him – So move the ball up to the 30-yard line.
In the fourth quarter against Independence, 14-10.
The Stuart Kramer Hunter Huss game is now Stuart Kramer leading Huss 14-12 with 9:31 in the third quarter.
Hand off to Harper once again. He's trying to get through a defender, and I think that's Mercer on the stop as some late hitting.
Yeah. And look, maybe a gain of one.
Okay.
They're gonna still keep it at the 30, so no gain on the play from start.
So, believe that's gonna make it. No, it's still gonna be second. It's gonna be second down. I thought it was
still second and five there. Final already. Huff defeated West Charlotte 31-0.
Well, that is a Mecklenburg County game, so they start at 7. Ball on the 30-yard line for the Warriors. So this has been a pretty long drive as Francis going in motion, going to be handoff to Harper. He gets across the line of scrimmage at the 25, the 20, out to the right side. He's at the 15, and he's going to be tackled by number two, Nate Curitan, at about the 10-yard line. So that's about been the biggest offensive play so far for the Warriors. It's going to be Walker Pharmacy and Newton first down.
Yeah, they're going to spot the ball at the 8-yard line, so give him a gain of 22. The longest run of the night for Harper.
And it's now 28-24 at Bessemer City. Bessemer City's making it a good game down there.
That's carry number 20 on the night for Harper.
Caleb Duell going to take it under center. And it's going to be a handoff to number two, Deshaun Francis. He's going to cut inside, cut outside, and he's going to be stopped by Will Mercer.
Mercer there, again, they did a good East Lincoln defense, stretched Francis east-west and was not able to cut up field. And
yeah, Mercer's been a force to reckon with in tonight's game.
Looks like they're going to mark him, lose a yard. It's going to be ball marked back at the 9-yard line.
Mercer, as we said earlier, he's a big one.
Yes, he is.
He's 6'5", 230, and he's only a junior, so Mustangs are ripped. Coach Bias real happy to see him in the lineup for next year. Dula going to take it under center once again. Hand it off to Harper this time. He's got some room on the left side, and he's going to be met by number 50, Eli Smith, the junior linebacker. See, he may have gotten a yard or two on the play. It's going to make it third down.
I think I'll spot the ball at the 8. Seven. Let them see that ball's at the 7, so give him a gain of 2.
So third down coming up. I know the Warriors are just trying to get some more points up on the board as it's out of reach here late in the third quarter. Mustangs want to hold them here. So still going to take it under center real tight. And a timeout on the field. It's going to be a timeout by the Warriors. So as they take a timeout here, we're going to take a quick timeout. 49-6 on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard. Mustangs on top.
It's Christmas Open House November 6th and 7th at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center on the Reevesville Road in Lincoln. All Christmas items will be on sale. Plus, enjoy free refreshments and register to win door prizes. Christmas Open House hours will be from 8 a.m. till 5:30 p.m. on Friday, November 5th, 8 a.m. till 5 on Saturday, November 6th, and 1 till 6 p.m. on Sunday, November 7th. The Christmas Open House at Carolina Hardware Garden and Pool Center, 969 Reevesville Road in Lincolnton.
And back here at David Clark Stadium as the West Caldwell Warriors just took their first time out of the second half. as we got a third and goal coming up. Ball at the 7-yard line. So the Warriors trying to get their first offensive touchdown of the ball game.
SD7 scored. They made him leading Wisconsin, West Lincoln, 29-7.
That would be a huge win for Maiden.
Yeah, Wisconsin. I don't know where that came from.
It's going to be a toss out to Tristan Harper. He's going to the right side. He's going to cut inside, cut outside, and he is tackled at about the 4-yard line.
Tackle on the play there, number 24, and that is Dalton Salerno. And
yeah.
Going to spot him down at the 4-yard line, so give Harper a 3-yard gain on that play.
So fourth and goal, I believe West Caldwell is going to just go for it here. In this situation, what would you do, Jason? Let's put the coaching hat on you. What would you do here?
Well, the passing hasn't been the only effective offense so far has been number 6. Maybe you think the defense is going to key in on him, maybe set up a quick play-action pass, but we've so far it's only been 2 completions. So trust the guy that's gotten you there so far as number 6 and see if you can pound it in for 4 yards.
As 4 seconds left on the play clock, they're going to have to hurry, and they burn another timeout. Yep. So we'll take another quick timeout here as the score – the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard. It is East Lincoln on top, big, 49-6 over the Warriors.
We're community-minded. We believe in what we do. We love this town. We live in just like you.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded. Just like you. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
We're community-minded just like you.
Back here at David Clark Stadium, as we do want to make an apology out to Full Throttle, as we forgot to mention that they are the sponsor, proud sponsor of the halftime show, the Full Throttle Power Sports and Gastonia halftime show. Go out down there and see what they're doing down there. Got a lot of great stuff down there.
Oh, yeah, get you some power toys.
Yeah, some power toys. We are around Lake Norman here
in
Denver.
Yeah, get nice jet skis or wave runners. Or, go on and enjoy that.
Fourth and goal coming up here. It's going to be a handoff to Harper. He's going to cut out to the left side, tripped up, and he's going to get into the end zone. Touchdown, Warriors.
4-yard touchdown run for Mr. Harper.
And as you said before the break, you said that West Caldwell is probably going to have to rely on Harper to get into the end zone instead of pass it, and that's what they do, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown.
Yep.
Out the kick, the point after is number 16, Zach Clay. Holding is Caleb Dula. So the first PAT for West Caldwell.
It bounced off the left upright and could not bounce in. See how he did on this next attempt. High snap, and it's up, and good.
So with 1:22 left in the third quarter of play, you know, the Carolina First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard is now East Lincoln on top, 49-13 over the Warriors of West Caldwell. We'll be back right after this quick break.
Here's some good policy from your local independent agent and auto owner's insurance. When you insure your home and car with us, you receive a multi-policy discount. And when you add auto owner's life insurance, you get a special discount on your home and car insurance. Auto owner's insurance will save you money on all of the insurance you already have. Now that's good policy. Auto owner's insurance, the no problem people.
Your local auto insurance agency is East Lincoln Insurance Agency on Highway 60 North in Denver. Give them a call at 704-483-3232.
And back here at David Clark Stadium, home of the East Lincoln Mustangs. Mustangs are on top, but West Caldwell just got a touchdown. 4-yard touchdown run by Tristan Harper.
Yeah, Mr. Harper there, that was ball carry number 23 on the night, getting his first touchdown. He's been the workhorse for the Warriors.
And that is the 10th touchdown of the year for Harper. He's over 1,000 yards tonight. Been the only good thing, really, for the Warriors. And kicking off for the Warriors is number 16, Zach Clay. It's all by himself back deep for the Mustangs. Is number 6, Jalen Frazier, another pooch kick.
And it's fair caught there by Nick Quigley. And it's going to be spotted down at the 31-yard line.
So, trying to see if Sage and Cameron are out there. No sign of Chaz yet.
Yeah, he's out there. He's already out there.
Oh, he's already out there. Did not see him. Yeah. He snuck by me.
Yeah. And the ball will be down. East Lake will start this drive from the 31-yard line.
Well, we got a running clock here, so the clock is ticking about 35 seconds and counting left in the third quarter. So Chaz has six total touchdowns as he could have an opportunity to tie the record once again. It's going to be a quick swing pass to Nick Quigley. He's across the 35, the 40, got some speed, turning on the Jets, goes out of bounds at about the 44-yard line. That's going to be good enough for a Walker Pharmacy of Newton first down.
Yeah, gain of 13 for Quigley on that play.
As they might have an opportunity to run one more play here, but I don't think they will.
And they're not. We're going to go to the end of the quarter now.
And so after three quarters of play on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, it's East Lincoln on top 49-13 over the West Caldwell Warriors. We'll be back right after this.
It's hard to believe First Federal Savings Bank has been serving this area for over 75 years. It's because of local people working and living right here in the community they serve. And they believe in giving back to the community by supporting our local schools, charities, and nonprofits. Services include checking accounts, savings, money markets, CDs, mobile banking, and online banking, with locations in Lincoln, Bogart City, Denver, and West Lincoln. Online at ffsb-nc.com. An equal housing lender and member FDIC.
Back here at David Clark Stadium, we are about to start the fourth quarter of play as the Mustangs are on top handily, pretty much in hand. They're going to win this game and continue all the streaks that they have.
Yeah, they come in tonight with the 35-game home winning streak. So I'm just looking to move that to 36 games. They had a 29-game conference winning streak. Look to move that to 30. And then a 24-game overall winning streak. Look to move that to 25.
Yeah, it's been a fun couple of years to be a Mustang fan.
Good 4 years.
4 years, yeah. Chas Rat's going to roll out. It's going to be a screen pass to number 49, I believe.
Darren Martin. He plays tight end. He's already had a touchdown earlier tonight. And now with his first reception.
Yeah, that touchdown came on a block punt. He recovered it and ran it in the end zone. As I think that's the loudest I've heard David Clark Stadium out of all the times I've been here.
And the ball's going to be spotted at the West Caldwell 45. So a gain of 11 on that catch.
Going to be a swing pass to Quigley once again. He's across the 45, across the 40. He's turning on the Jets, across the 30, and tripped up at about the 25-yard line. Man, Quigley, don't get to see him as much, but, man, he is a fast runner. We know that for sure.
That's a gain of 20 there at the ball's marked at 25.
East Lincoln now on top. Lincoln now on top 52-0 over Newton Conover, just getting uglier down there in downtown Lincoln.
Surratt continues his I'm not going to say it. Not going to say it.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to say it if I were you. You know,
nope,
you jinxed the punter earlier in the first half.
Nope. And final tonight, South Iredell defeated North Lincoln 43-0.
Also, in that running back now for the Mustangs is Chandler Jones. It's going to be a handoff to Jones. He's across the 25 and going to get a good amount of yardage.
Yeah, getting inside the 20, going to be spotted down. They're going to spot him at the 18.
Yes, and to all those people watching, we did see him in some action, Chandler Jones, when he – played against Bandies. He did score a touchdown in the fourth quarter against the Trojans.
Gain of 7 on that play from Jones. His first carry of the night.
It's going to make it 2nd and 3 coming up for the month.
Pratt's night is done. In at quarterback now is number 7, Marcus Graham.
He is only a freshman. And a low snap, it's off. Marcus Graham, the ball's still loose.
And it's going to be recovered by Wes Caldwell there at the 20-yard line.
And the fumble is recovered by number 28, Mikron Ashley. I know I messed that up there. He is a 5'6", 148 pounds.
I guess it's a Mikron, or maybe you had to say.
Well, actually, East Lincoln actually –
They're going to say the ball carrier was down, so no fumble.
And he Graham lost control of that snap too, but a flag on the play. So Graham not getting off to the best start here tonight.
So ball's going to be pushed back to the 26-yard line. So Marcus Graham had lost a yard on that fumble.
Graham gets the snap this time. He's going to hand it off to Chandler Jones. He gets across 25, but not much else.
Spot him there at the 24, so give him a gain of two.
So fourth and eight coming up for the Mustangs. Looks like they're going to be going for it here. Graham takes a snap. He's going to hand it off to Chandler Jones once again. He's across the 20 and is stopped at about the 18-yard line. It's going to be a turnover on downs.
Yep. Gain of six on the play for Chandler Jones.
So the Warriors will come out here once again. We are under a running clock. So 8 minutes and counting here for the Warriors and Mustangs. And the Warriors have it first and 10. Ball on their own 18. And Harper, the handyman for the Warriors, is going to get the ball. He's got some hard-earned yardage there. It's going to be about 4 yards.
They're going to mark him at the 23-yard line. Gain of four.
And it's going to be a fake to Harper, a little
pass attempt there out in the flats to Brooks, and it's incomplete.
So it's going to be third down, as nothing's really going here for the Warriors, minus that first drive in the second half. It's and that one fumble recovery, it's been all Mustangs here tonight at David Clark Stadium.
South Caldwell now cutting into that St. Stephen's lead. It's now St. Stephen's leading 25-20 with 4:32 remaining in the ballgame over South Caldwell. Big game down in Kinston tonight. It's Green Central leading Kinston 21-20. Heard it's called the game of the century tonight down there.
And Kinston is graduating 21 seniors after this year, so pretty big. Caleb Dula going to hand it off to Harper once again. He's going to go all the way to the left side of the field, across the 25, across the 30, and is going to be forced out of bounds at about
34. Let's see. Spot him at the 34-yard line.
And that's going to be good enough for Walker Pharmacy of Newton first down.
The gain of 11 down there. Okay,
so it's basically been the Trustin Harper show on the West Caldwell side.
Yeah, without Titus Tucker, their other weapon, is he's having to be the workhorse tonight for them.
Dula's going to hand it off to Deshaun Harris. He's got some room on the outside. He's across the 40 and is going to be tripped up short of the 45, but I think that's going to be good enough to move the chains once again for the Warriors.
Yeah, they're going to spot him there at the 44, so give him a gain of 10. That's his best run of the night so far. Francis, last name Francis, Deshaun Francis.
And the correction, that was Deshaun Francis.
End of the third quarter, Lincolnton leading Newton Conover 52-0.
Man, it's going to be another handoff. It's going to be Elijah Brooks this time. He's got some room on the outside. Cross midfield. He's still on
his
there.
Feet, and he's going to be stopped down at the 45-yard line. And on the play is number 88. I do not have him on the roster.
Yeah, do not have him on the roster. Got some rosters on the wall, but do not see an 88. But nice play to stop Elijah Brooks, because if you can't get him down, it's danger.
Gain of 11 for Mr. Brooks.
Ooh, and another player down.
Yeah,
I think it might be Brooks.
Have an injury timeout.
Yes. Looks like it could be Elijah Brooks there. I think he's maybe just a little shaken up. No, is it?
No, it's number. Yeah, that is Brooks there.
Yeah.
Slow to get up.
And this is not good for go down.
No.
But Brooks doesn't seem as serious. He's walking gingerly off the field.
Another SD7 score update at the end of the third quarter is Maiden leading West Lincoln 36-7. Thomas Jefferson in the fourth quarter now. Thomas Jefferson leading Bessemer City 35-24.
So has been an interesting game. Bessemer City giving Thomas Jefferson a run for its money right now. Going down with a fight at least. And Pisgah is currently on top of North Henderson 31-7. And Dula going to hand it off to Harper once again. He's going to get across the 45 and is stopped at about the 42-yard line. So a good gain of three on the play for Harper.
Down to the 42.
And now another SD7 score. Maiden now on top of West Lincoln 36-7 at the end of the third quarter. So it's 21-7 at one point, but Maiden's starting to pull away.
Yes, they are.
As we have a running clock, so when I tell you how much time's left, that's why 3.5 minutes remaining in the game. It's going to be a
keeper by Dula. He's going to option pitch to Harper.
Harper looks like he's got the first down again. Yes, he does.
They're going to spot him down the 35-yard line.
Okay, by number 6, Preston Harper. Stopped by number 90, Herman Hernandez.
So, well, no, actually, they're not going to give him the first down.
No, just give him a few inches.
Well, last time we saw this situation, they gave East Lincoln the first down, but it looks like they're going to stand by their decision here. It's going to be third in inches.
So gain six on the play for.
Yeah, we jumped the gun there. And a high snap.
Goes over here to quarterback, and Harper picks it up. He picks it up at his own 48-yard line. He's reversed, losing ground again. And
losing yard. Oh, my gosh.
Still on his feet, and then he's going to fall down and get strips down at the West Caldwell 47-yard line.
And in a nutshell, that's been the night for West Caldwell.
So they're going to spot. It's a loss of. Yeah, they're going to spot the ball at the West Caldwell 48 is where they're going. Loss of 16 yards on that. On that run for Mr. Harper. And a final from Kings Mountain. Kings Mountain shuts out Chase 24-0.
Not the flashiest win, but they get the job done.
Mountain Island Charter with the shutout against the homeschool team.
Greenville, I believe.
Yeah, Greenville homeschool. Mountain Island Charter wins 47-0.
And it's going to be a handoff to Deshaun.
Francis there. He reverses field. He has the left side all by himself. Now he gets across the 35 and is nailed by number 43. And that is Chandler Jones with the tackle.
Lane Wood. He almost got the first down.
But there is a flag on the play back at the 49-yard line. So, with all that running, like it's going to be coming back.
And this has been up there with the most flags we've seen all year, Jason.
It is.
Chop block, and that was against Caleb Dula there.
And the flag is thrown at the 49, so basically it's a gain of one on the play for Deshaun Francis. And now
and just going to make it fourth and a mile. There's less than a minute left in the ball game now, Jason. Just might as well throw a prayer, maybe, if you want to get more points on the board.
Yeah, ball spotted back at the 33-yard line.
And there's Caleb Dula still going to take it under center here for the Warriors. It's going to be another handoff to Harper. Harper gets across the 35, across the 40, and is going to be still on his feet at the 45. He's going to somehow get to about the 50. But well short of the first down.
So gain of 17.
And with the running clock, that should do it for tonight's ball game. And the final here at David Clark Stadium. East Lincoln still undefeated as they win this one handedly. 49-13 over the West Caldwell Warriors on the First Federal Savings Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard. Please stay tuned with us after the game as we have a commercial break, as you'll be listening to the Carolina Trust Bank of Denver and Lincoln scoreboard, as we'll give the Parker Farm Service of Kings Mountain offensive player of the game and the Weston Sales and Vale defensive player of the game. So we'll be back right after these commercial breaks.
The new Coyote 3510 tractor is now in stock at Weston Sales and Vale. It's what you've been waiting for, a 34-horsepower Coyote tractor for only $17,900. And now you can take $2,500 off all Coyote DK Series tractors. Plus, get a free loader on all Coyote CK Series tractors. And buy a new Coyote UTV and get 0% financing. Come on in now for all the details at West End Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail. Online at westendsales.com.
It's time to book your Christmas party now. And there's no better place in our area than Homestead's Grill and Tap House in Lincoln. With two banquet rooms available with accommodations up to 125. Plus, they do on- and off-site caterings such as wedding rehearsal dinners, birthdays, showers, and more. Check out the NFL Sunday ticket, plus all-you-can-eat ribs, wings, and salad bar Friday and Saturdays for $19.99. And try the new US 1 short rib burger for only $9.49. Homestead's Grill and Tap House, 357 North Generals Boulevard in Lincoln, and coming in November, a new additional location in Denver.
Get the cutting edge, get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower that raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best, cut with a Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700.
It's the end of the season tire blowout sale at Full Throttle Power Sports in Gastonia. Michelin Pilot Power tires start at $99.99 and Continental Motion tires start at $75. Plus, get end of the season deals on the remaining Yamaha watercraft. Plus, great motorcycle deals like a 2015 Yamaha R3 for $49.90 and the new 2015 Yamaha FZ6R for $69.89. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 off I-85 at 100 Indian Walk in Lowell. Online at ncfullthrottle.com.
It's the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln. Get $1,000 in rebates on select Kubota tractors, plus zero money down, zero financing for 60 months. Offer good on the Kubota L Series and the Kubota BX Series tractors. But hurry, offer in soon. Don't miss the Kubota Power to Do Great Things sales event at Al Lane's Kubota of Lincoln, 3636 East Highway 27 in Lincoln. Online at KubotaofLincoln.com.
It's time to power up with Buddy's Home Furnishings Power Up Package. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you with same-day delivery. Rent an Ashley Mayer sectional with your choice of an Ashley Quindon bedroom set or a Kenmore washer and dryer or a 55-inch LG smart LED TV. Only $37.99 per week. Find out how you can own it all in less than a year. And you're approved up to $2,500 in store credit at Buddy's Home Furnishings, 1116 East Main Street in Lincoln.
Hey, David, do you have the X-Plan?
The X-Plan?
Yeah, the X-Plan. Over 3,000 companies across the nation offer the X-Plan to their employees. And if you have the X-Plan, you get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford in Shelby.
How do I know?
Well, just ask your employer or check with Crossroads Ford. It's available from companies like Walmart, Timken, AT&T, Wix, PPG, Big Lots, Food Lion, and more.
I'm checking today.
Ask if you have the X-Plan and get special pricing from Ford and Crossroads Ford. 1775 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Get the X-Plan today.
Hello, my name's George Smith. I suffer from sleep apnea and decided to do something about it. With a note from my general physician, I went to see Dr. John Cloninger, who made me an oral appliance to wear each night while I sleep. It's an easy appointment, and after receiving the mouthpiece, it has totally changed my life. Suffering from high blood pressure and a lack of sleep, with these appliances, I now feel normal. My blood pressure has come down. My wife has quit fussing at me for snoring so loud, and I'm breathing better. So I strongly urge anyone suffering from sleep apnea to call Dr. John Cloninger's office and make an appointment. It's changed my life, and I know you should let it change yours.
See Dr. John Cloninger III on Doncher Drive in Lincolnton. Phone 704-735-0765.
Wake up, everybody. Just kidding. You can snooze thanks to Mickey D's new all-day breakfast menu. It's my favorite meal of the day. And when you're in the mood, it's available now. Anytime, so come through. Hot cakes and sausage of the chain, it don't stop. Golden hash brown served all day round the clock.
Introducing McDonald's new all-day breakfast menu, featuring a savory sausage biscuit with egg sandwich. Get the special taste of breakfast time at a time that works for you.
Right around the clock.
Menu items vary. Deliciousness doesn't.
And back here at
David Clark Stadium here on the campus of East Lincoln High School, where Evan, it started out a little slow for East Lincoln. They had two turnovers to start the game. One of them returned for a touchdown. But then once they got started, they scored 49 unanswered before West Caldwell got on the board again. And it was East Lincoln 49-13, as we are in the Carolina Trust Bank of Denver and Lincolnton postgame show. And we have some awards to give out.
The Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain Offensive Player of the Game. Well, if you don't know who it is, you must have been living under a rock during this game.
It's no other than Mr. Chad Surratt, who on tonight did it with his arm. My stats are unofficial. I have him at 19 for 19, four touchdown passes, 312 yards. And his favorite target tonight, of course, was his little brother, Sage. I showed him that 9 catches, 2 TDs for 173 yards. Cameron Dollar had 4 catches for 90 yards for 2 touchdowns. And then leading the tack on the ground is Colton Banks. I had him at 7 carries for 46 yards. Before we give out the Defensive Player Award, just give some stats for West Caldwell. The workhorse tonight was Trustin Harper, showing with 29 carries for 124 yards and a touchdown. Showing passing so far tonight, Caleb Dula was just 2 of 8 passing for 10 yards. And our defensive player of the game,
The Weston Sales and Vale defensive player of the game goes to Will Mercer.
Yeah, Mr. Mercer, we called his name quite a few times tonight. He was all over the place. Big hit, and he's a big guy. He's 6'5", 230 pounds. He's just a junior. And he's played that defensive end the last 2 weeks, so he's been very impressive there at that defensive end spot.
Yes, and of course, unfortunately, the bad thing about tonight's game is the talking point is going to be about Titus Tucker. Unfortunately, he was injured, did not return. He got injured on the first play from scrimmage. Prayers go out to him. Hopefully, he's all right. Elijah Brooks also got hurt late in the game, too. Do not know how severe it is. So, also, big score right now. Hunter Hunt's now up 20-14 with 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter against Kramer. Big implications in that game.
Yeah, for playoff purposes. And then they did see a final from Lincolnton. Lincolnton shuts out Newton Conover 52-0 tonight.
So, this has been the SD7 Lincoln County Game of the Week on KTCBroadcasting.com and LincolnCounty.com, and on the Ustream app as well. If you want to look at more of the scores and get all the updates, listen to the Renato Mall postgame show. You can watch it on KTCBroadcasting.com and on WLON 1050 1490 AM and WCSL 1590 AM as that will be after the Crest game. There's no Shelby game this week. It's usually after Shelby game. But once again, the Renato Auto Mall postgame show, Dennis Davis, Terry Reinhart, Kevin Hastings, as well as a couple of others, Steve Roberts, the very energetic Steve Roberts, Steve Robay, will be on the postgame show tonight. Well, I'm Evan Ludwig, been alongside Jason Barber. Shout out to Shandy Clark, cameraman, yes. as uh, it's final once again here at David Clark Stadium. 49-13, East Lincoln wins and stays undefeated. Good night, everybody.